Let's see. Stream.me is my special little testing ground for the pre-stream. You guys get to talk to me a little bit sooner before the YouTube people. Just a little bit early. I only got a minute left. I better at everyone. Let them know. At everyone. Okay. Stream.me, Kiwi Farms, and the YouTube link. Uh-oh. I'm going to be late soon. This stream's going to be a mess. I got stuff all over the place. I got clips and clips and clips and talking points. Oh, jeez. Is my mic and stuff fine? My mic and all good? Alright. Let's see. That's the right place. Man at the internet. Okay. Let's send it. Pile in, my friends. Waiting for the mic check, by the way. Is my mic good? My mic's not good. Oh, jeez. Don't at me. All right. We have to go. Okay. Preview. Stream status good. Previewing, syncing to player, preparing the live stream. Please wait a moment. Make sure I got my song ready. Yes, I do. Okay. Wait, just hurry the fuck up, YouTube. I've been waiting a moment. There we go. Okay. Going quiet. All right, 3, 2.
This is a Liquid Richard production.
Welcome to Band World. I make shitty content. Help your boy out. Subscribe, donate, or get the fuck out.
Who can fuck the ugliest bitch? I got you. Give me the fat bitch over there. I got you. That's what I want.
That's who I am.
That's what I want.
450-pound man.
West Coast nigga. It's a way of life.
You think exercise ain't gonna do anything for me? All it's gonna do is make me hungry.
Nobody wants to help me.
We could be at the fucking club, right? You don't like the slack pussy? Go for the prime cut.
That pussy's not gonna slay itself.
Slay itself.
All day slay.
All day slay.
Nigga.
Go bother somebody like fucking Syndicate. Who steals money from children and drives Lamborghinis his entire life. That's all it is. Drives Lamborghinis. Hey! Who can fuck the ugliest bitch? I got you. Give me the fat bitch over there. I got you. That's what I want.
That's who I am.
That's what I want.
450-pound man.
Who can fuck the ugliest bitch? I got you. Give me the fat bitch over there. I got you. That's what I want.
That's who I am.
That's what I want.
All day slay.
Shout out Sean Rankin.
Lord of the Wings. Well, big ups to Liquid Dick and shout out to Sean Rankin. That is that is Wings of Redemption. Rings of Redemption is to a locale called DSP. What Chantel, very fittingly, is to Amberlynn. DSP's the glory hog. Amberlynn's the glory hog in the female realm, but they have their counterparts, which are similar and distinct and odd and twisted ways. I hope everybody is having a fantastic Wednesday, the best day of the week, because it is the week that I stream. I did not intend on doing a video on another fat person this soon. I couldn't help it. I got titties in the email, and they said, please do a stream on Chantel. And I'm like, fine. I guess I have to now. That's what happens. You start streaming shit that girls like, and they send you titties in the email and start asking you to pick on other chicks. So I my hands are tied, unfortunately. Chantel is is not pleasant. Chantel is, I would say, Chantel is... Chat, stop giving me shit, okay? I'm just a man, okay? Chantel, I would say, is worse than Amberlynn. That's probably a contentious statement, right? But Amber Lynn at least has like little story arcs. Amber Lynn at least has shit going on. She you know, she's fat and she's kind of a loser, but she bumbles around very energetically and leaves trailblazes. Her scooter leaves like streaks of fire down the road wherever she goes. And Chantel does not. Chantel's like the poor man's version of Amber Lynn. And people, you know, people, especially with that video Amber Lynn did of her eating just a BK chicken sandwich. No, I'm not the one getting off on laughing at fat chicks. I happen to have fans who apparently get off on me laughing at fat chicks. So I gotta do what I gotta do. Chantel is literally a feeder. Literally. And I'll prove this. I'll prove this. Because even though Amber Lynn does her gross eating videos, right? She does a lot of other vlogs and stuff. She just does shit. She vlogs all the time. And, you know, they're shitty. But they are what they are. Chantel's is not. Let me show you this to prove my point. This is from her channel. This is her playlist, right? So she organizes all her videos into different categories. Hilda and Dr. Morris, Carpetbagger, Mukbangs, Hauls, Bomb or Bust, Storytime Vlogs and Other Nonsense, Makeup Tutorials, and GRWN. I don't know what GRWM is, but apparently she's not too into it. Because out of all of her videos, 259 of them are Mukbangs. The rest of them make up less than 30, less than 40 videos. So she that's the majority of her content. And what her channel started out as was a makeup thing. Like, you know, okay, I'm fat, but I'm going to do my makeup and make myself look pretty, right? She found out very quickly that she made a lot more money eating. And sorry, I got a message. She's just segued on that. And now all of her vlogs are her eating. And I think this is almost a defensive mechanism to the point where it's hard to watch. It's hard to hate watch her. It's very easy to hate watch Amber Lynn. You just sit down and you watch her and she's like, hey guys. And then she talks about shit that nobody cares about for 30 minutes and you laugh at her. Chantel is hard, especially for me, and I have to take measures this stream to make sure that I can actually make it through all the stuff that I want to play. I've clipped out what I can. A lot of her stuff comes from non-eating vlogs, but she is a disgusting eater. And when I was in school, you know, I would sit middle desk, you know, 5x5 rows of tables and chairs. If somebody was chewing gum in that room, I knew exactly where they were sitting, even if they were behind me. I got the hearing to pinpoint precisely where these noisy eaters were. And Chantel is evil incarnate for somebody like me. Insufferable. And just the worst eater I've ever heard. So before I get started, before I go any further, Chantel was kind of a natural discovery for me. And people are calling me a feeder right now, specifically because over my eight Hanukkah streams, I did nothing but look at fat chicks eating. And Chantel was something that I found along the way, and it kind of piqued my interest. And I wish I was watching a lot of these videos for the first time again, because my initial reaction to this shit was comedic perfection, if I do say so myself. I think revulsion was the correct word. There were some people that were worse than her that I watched during these streams, but Chantel was up towards the top. So before I go further, Chantel is actually a bully. And we are not a bully stream. We're just talking amongst ourselves here. And really, I would prefer it if Chantel never saw this video. I don't give a shit if people watch my videos. I'm not making it for them. I'm making it for my special friends in chat. And all of you are my special friend. And so are people who email me nudes. But she will see this because she is full Fahrenheit 451 when it comes to criticism. And there are a lot of people in chat watching who are probably women who have done drama videos on Chantel at some point and have been met with DMCA copyright strikes against their channels that they would have to contest. And if you contest these strikes, right, you have to dox yourself. And that's a great way to make sure that criticism stays put. Because Chantel doesn't just stop there. She gets her information, she'll fuck with you. And we'll go over that. So a lot of people want to keep archives of her stuff because she deletes stuff all the time. And I wish I had more videos because I've heard more stories than what I can show. But she will crush any people trying to archive her stuff. She'll scare them away with DMCA claims that they have to fight by doxing themselves. And she's very meticulous in grooming her comments. She doesn't lock it down, but she makes sure that they're all positive. And I warn you, Chantel, should you watch this, I am not some little teensy bopper trying to keep her address secret. This is my address. If you want to DMCA strike me, this is where you send the paperwork, and I absolutely will fight in court. And if you DMCA strike my channel, I will contest it. And if you don't take me to court after doing that, you will get a strike against your channel for abusing the DMCA system. So just don't fuck with me, please. I just want to laugh. I want to share the gift. It's Christmas after all. It's Christmas. And I want you to pay special attention to that final line. United States of America. See, that's the important bit. This ain't Canada. We got freedom of speech. We got the freedom to laugh at fat people. That's why we have so many of them. All right. I have a list of stuff. I got my notebook. People were sending me notes. M's Pex and A Random Thought helped me out a lot with this stream. It's completely foreign territory for me, except for the gross eating videos. I mentioned that she's worse than Amberlynn, and part of that has to do with the fact she's not on any kind of journey. It's kind of interesting when you look at Amberlynn, how Amberlynn started with this idea, I'm going to make a vlog channel for losing weight, and this promise to the public is going to keep me invested, and it's going to keep me, just stuck to my promises. Chantel is the opposite. Her dieting stuff came after she started doing her eating videos, her feeding videos, to be completely honest. They're obviously fetish material. And this is kind of what that looks like. She has tried, as Imspex put it very, very eloquently, she has tried literally every diet except eating less and walking more. She has tried all sorts of weird, crazy shit. She started doing vegan stuff like within the last 2 weeks. None of it's worked, obviously. There's this picture, which I'm quite fond of, showing her decay over the years. Not precisely a success in terms of dieting. And I wish her the best when it comes to dieting. I wish everybody success. But in terms of visible progress, I would say that this is quite the inverse. Chantel, unlike Amberlynn as well, is a lot more, I would say, ashamed. She has the capacity for shame. You know, Amberlynn rolls around on her scooter a lot, doesn't give a shit what you think about her. Chantel does not tend to take pictures of herself in full body. It's always her, you know, either in the car or behind a table, some sort of obstruction where you can't really see the full body. This is, again, I'm not trying to be unflattering here. This is the only picture, only video, only thing I could find of her that showed her from the waist up. Everything else is just, I think this is, I don't think this is too recent. This is from one of her diet videos. You can see this exact picture in the thumbnail. But as far as I know, this is the only picture I've ever seen of her where she is, where she's actually not sitting behind something or hiding her body in some way. So Chantel is somebody who likes to keep up appearances, likes to make themselves, you know, the makeup stuff, making themselves look as good as possible. Again, as opposed to Amberlynn, who just does not, could not possibly give less of a fuck, will be as gross and trollish about about not sticking to her diet as possible, bragging about getting a dietitian and how little people know about diets as she sits and eats a chicken sandwich. That is brass balls. That's fucking impressive in how little concern she has for the people watching. Okay. I do have this video, but I don't know if I want to play it yet. That's something to save towards the end. Yeah, let's keep that one. I just want to say that she's openly revolting. Like, she may not, you know, she may try to keep up appearances in terms of, like, actual visual content, but she has no concern whatsoever for not appearing gross or manipulative. Oh. What? I did see, somebody just sent me this in PM. I did see this, I swear. But, oh, I can't open this in OBS for some reason. Let me open it in Firefox. I did see this picture while browsing, but I thought it was one of the, I swear, I'm not being a dick when I say this, I swear I thought it was one of the Slayton sisters. I did not think that that was actually Chantel. There's a different angle for people curious. Again, I did see this in Google Images, but I thought that was somebody else. All right. And though I don't really consider these streams any kind of revenge, I don't think of it like, you know, some people think of making videos on somebody as a kind of internet vigilantism. I don't. I just think people are funny, and I like to if something makes me laugh, I like to share that. But Chantal is mean-spirited. That's the best way to put it. I have a different slide prepared for this. So here's a fun one right off the bat. Somebody says, "Have you thought about gastric bypass?" in one of her videos, and she gets two replies. This person, if you watch her videos, she's talked about it. "Have you thought about a lobotomy? I hear those are helpful too." And she liked both of these. The second one's kind of funny because she's basically endorsing this chick to have her brain cut out. But it's true. This was actually a reply to the top comment. "I feel your pain. Walking at our weights is tough. Would you ever consider bariatric surgery? I ask because I'm considering it now. That combined with therapy." And that's a reply to an Amber Lynn video talking about gastric bypass. So just being a dick to people for no reason, endorsing people in her comments, being dicks for her so she can save face. This is just a random pinned tweet on one of her videos, one of her feeder videos. "The 200 dislikes is proof that not so many do not understand, oh, that so many do not understand food addiction and have a condemning attitude towards it. If I was a heroin addict, though, the sympathy would be pouring in. This experience makes me want to consider sharing my personal life online. People would want you to be honest and real, then ridicule you when you are." that I didn't realize when I glanced over the screenshot how ironic that little line is. "This experience would make me want to reconsider sharing my personal life online." Yeah, no fucking shit. Just as a general rule of thumb, if you don't want people to tear into something, you probably should not share it online. Just a thought. But, you know, she gets her ass kissers, making her feel good again. And she probably, you know, she curates her comments so well that whatever criticism is there is shadow banned. Keep in mind, even if you can comment on her videos, she probably has it so that if you're in a different account besides your own, she can't see them, which is why her comments are so crystal clean when you look through them. What you can't shadow ban is dislikes, which is why that affects her. She cuts off likes ratios in some of her videos, but trust me, I know this from experience, looking at my console. If you turn off likes, dislikes being public information, you still see them. So even if she does that, your dislike is not in vain. Just a thought. And this is, I don't know the full details to it. Maybe somebody can hit me up in one of my avenues, one of my ways to get at me. But this is in response to a suicide, apparently. So she says, "What a disgusting, hateful, slobby piece of shite. You won't be missed." And I don't know the full details to this, but apparently the person she's talking to in this comment actually did kill themselves. So this is going to read particularly nasty when I show you a clip in a second. Just keep this in mind. This isn't a comment towards somebody who did end up killing themselves. But before I get there, let me read this post by somebody called Manny Cunt. I did not name them that. They named themselves. Manny Cunt was a friend of Amberlynn, and she joined the Kiwi Farms. Now, Chantal likes to pretend she doesn't know what the Kiwi Farms is. In fact, I got this clip.
What the hell is Kiwi Farms?
Likes to pretend that Kiwi Farms is not a thing. She doesn't know anything about it. Now, she's broken on that by now. But, oh yeah, I'm sure she knows it. But she liked to pretend for a while that she didn't. And Manny Cunt was kind of the breaking of the dam for that. So this is from the Chantal show to Manny Cunt, who was one of her friends. Okay, so if you could stop acting like a crazy teenager and creating a million fake accounts trying to harass me, that would be wonderful. You're taking this way too far, and guess what? It's all your fault. You started this. You flip out because you see that I called one of my trolls an exceptional individual. Oh, that's retard. if you see exceptional individual in the Kiwi Farms, that's our word filter for retard. I just like that filter. In the figurative sense, a long time ago in self-defense, yet I have screenshots of me saying it to you on Facebook as a joke, but that time it was okay, right? All bullshit excuses for you to be pissed for no reason because you have self-hatred issues, which is why you used to cut yourself and threaten suicide, and now you are taking it out on me. You sit there and talk about my eating disorder with my trolls, but what happened? What about the self-harm that you used to do? Again, don't come for me unless your closet is clean, which it is not. I never mentioned anything about rape, etc. You are making shit up now. You are in the wrong here. As a friend, if you were offended by something I said a year ago online, for fuck's sake, all you had to do was message me on Instagram, but instead, like a coward, you blocked me and become my biggest troll. How would you feel it if it was your kids who were being trolled online? Our friendship is over if we ever had one, which is apparent to me that we never did, but it is so, so, so low of you to bring up 20 years of information, most lies and exaggerations, stuff that we talked about in confidence as friends, but you have no boundaries and you have no morals and you have no soul. Oh, jeez. She's getting fucking biblical on Manny Cunt. You are in a very dark place, and I would get help for that if I were you. Tell me, how as a parent do you have time to sign up for to forums with edgy names like Manny Cunt when you are the single mother of two? What kind of example are you setting for them? I know you are in Yarmouth, and I have all the screenshots of the harassment you have been putting me through. For what? A lousy comment I made? Go cry in a corner for fuck's sake and grow up. You've always been a whack job. And all of Cornwall knows that. If you ever mention another thing about me online, I will be checking. I will be sending all of the screenshots to Child Protective Services in your town and to the authorities for harassment. This has gone on too far. Enough is enough. And by the way, honey, BB has his permanent residency, so shove your threats up your ass. And sure, a lot of online idiots hate me, hell, at this point, with the time they spend on me. It's a fucking fan club. And you can now say that you're just as low as they are. Congratulations. My life is great. I don't need to spend all day harassing others. Good luck with that, LOL. Hashtag winning. And no, that's not a joke. She actually signed off, hashtag winning. Okay, Manny Cunt has apparently been an asshole to Chantal. But in this email, it's actually particularly interesting because I believe Manny Cunt smokes weed or something. And her threat was essentially, if you fuck with me again, I'm going to call Child Protective Services and tell them that these kids are being taken care of by a drug addict. And then if Child Protective Services came over and saw the two kids with drugs in the house, I think by law, they have to do something about it. So, like, you might get put on probation or, you know, it can be a mess depending on prior offenses. So it's a pretty big stick to swing. Manny Cunt did not take that warning, apparently, and posted this directly to the forum, and for that, we thank her. But that is not the end of it. Where did that go? Take my apology back. Is this it? Yes, this is it.
I just want to, like, update and say, you know, my video yesterday, I made an apology. And you know what? I take it back. I take it back, especially to Kathy.
Why is it muting?
Is the person who is harassing.
Oh, that's the line. That's the person who capped this VOD removing the name from the. I was like, why is the audio dropping out? No, it's just the censoring that the editor did.
And I'm just not gonna. They are basic. She's basically now just she's relentless and threatened me first. Remember, I told you she threatened. Immigration. Here's the screenshot.
I'll turn this up in a second.
She messages me with these fake accounts like on the daily basis about 6 times a day, threatening to take to call immigration on BB, who's here on a permanent residency. So have fun with that. Threatening to call the cops when she's the one harassing me, and I replied to her in email. So in an email I said to her, you know, you're gonna threaten me. Well, you know. I'm going to call Child Protective Services on you. And you know what? I stand by that because I don't think that a parent who cyberbullies and harasses people online all day.
Okay, just so you know, you're going to hear her cat throughout this video. And we'll get to the cat in a second. But no, you're not being accosted in your own home. That is her animal being noisy.
And makes usernames like Manicunt. To harass people, and gets high all day, deserves to have kids, but that's just me. I think that's wrong. I think that's...
Okay, to reiterate, if you get high and you have kids, you deserve to have your children taken away from you, especially if you post on the Kiwi farms.
What kind of example are you setting for these children? It's just really, really wrong. I'm just saying, you know, I stand by that. So, yeah, I don't feel bad for saying your full name because you've said mine many times. And you're spreading slander because everything you say is a fucking lie. So I just want you to know,
libel is written.
This is the last of my attention you're getting because you clearly want it. Have fun doing what you're doing online. You're not gonna bully me off the internet. I don't give a shit what you think about me. I don't care what anyone thinks about me. You could think I'm a bitch, but you're the one with the name cunt in it. So you're the bigger one. And you started this.
Oh no, you didn't. That's that when I first heard that I actually like physically fucking cringed. your name has cunt in it, so you're the bigger one. Like fucking got him.
You had no right to, I did nothing to you, and you had no right to do this in the first place, so I'm defending myself, and the mentality online that you are the bitch for defending yourself is just so ass backwards, it makes no sense, so yeah, so you can shove it, sit on it and rotate, screenshot that for your profile picture, biatch. It's really sad that you have no life and that's all you do all day. Like, you're a very soulless person and no, I don't think you should be raising children. I really don't. I don't care if that makes me sound bad. I really think it's horrible that they have you as an example when you have guys, different men all day and I have screenshots, so don't even go there. And that's what you do to them too. You continually have these different men in your life and then you flip out on them and harass them, and you've done that. I've seen it firsthand, and now you're doing that to me. It's really, really pathetic and it's really toxic and not cool.
Toxic.
So yeah, anyways, have fun with your life. You think my life is bad, but at least I'm trying to do something to better myself and not sign up to forums all day long to try and harass people. So that I will always have one up on you. So see you later.
Boy, oh boy, do I fucking hate the word toxic. It's just the worst. No, her entire rant, like, that was one of, like, the most pathetic attempts to be catty I've ever seen. Because it's just like, I'm just gonna make fun of your kids for fucking, how long is this video? For four minutes? I'm just gonna say that you're a bad mother because you fuck a lot of guys and smoke weed. I guess being slutty when you have kids is kind of gross, but I don't know. It seems a little bit better than having them in a fucking orphanage. just my thought. What do I know, though? I'm just some idiot from the Kiwi Farms. Whatever, what even that is. Whatever the Kiwi Farms may be. That's where I'm from, and I don't matter. Actually, I take that back. I do matter significantly. Because now I get to bring up this. I mentioned that she's mean-spirited, right? She tends to try and get at people. Tries to make them hurt when she doesn't like them. Well, I happen to have a cute little encounter with this person. Not directly. I don't think she mentions me directly. But she went after my baby. And it's one of the most pathetic attempts at virtue signaling that I've ever seen. So let's take a look at what that looks like. Uh-oh, that's how you know it's serious. We got a trigger warning right up front.
Okay.
I think this is her as a kid. I have no fucking idea what this has to do with anything, though.
Hey guys, today's video, I'm gonna put a trigger warning because it may be triggering for some people. It talks about somebody's suicide, and I just want to really bring awareness to this.
Jump scare.
This actually really affected me on a level that, I mean, I just feel like I need to do something about it. I don't know, just like give her even just a moment of time.
Let's take a second. This is a very serious video on a very serious subject, but one, three chins. Sorry.
awareness to her situation. A viewer. So there's a forum, Kiwi Farms, that goes around and makes fun of.
I thought you didn't know what it was.
Basically, people that it gives them somewhere they can go and safely make fun of people, dox people, which doxing is putting out people's personal information. They have 700 pages on Amber Lynn Reed. I have a fucking page. And then this girl,
full disclosure,
Canadian autistic girl. She,
oh, geez.
Her name was Julie Terryberry. She has over 200 pages worth.
You couldn't find a better picture.
Of pure
really
making fun of her, basically. And a viewer notified me of that, you know, said that place is disgusting. Look up this girl. She killed herself because of the online bullying. So Julie Terryberry, all right, she killed herself because of all of the... One would argue that, you know, she was suicidal to begin with. So basically, I'll just insert screenshots of her Kiwi Farms page. You can look it all up. It's all there. Julie Terryberry, a Canadian autist living in a shed. So 200 pages worth.
This is like an anti-Kiwi Farms video. You know, like when you take up a Kiwi Farms thread and you just read through it, like a bunch of people do. And then you make jokes about it. But this is like the virtue signaling version of that. You take up a thread and then you whine about it for 7 minutes.
Bullying a girl with, let's see, they list her problems, so they're well aware of them. Julie has ADHD, Asperger's, autism, is suicidal, emotional, and mental train wreck. So they proceed to go for 200 pages worth of putting up pictures of her when she's cut herself, just downright disgusting shit. And it's like, then over here we have her obituary. She was 19 when she killed herself. Sure, she may have been suicidal, but I'm sure being bullied to that extent doesn't help. And you know what? You know what the Kiwi Farms response was? I saw a comment somebody posted asking about the death, and somebody wrote, "I'm going back to jerking off. This is ridiculous." Mm-hmm. How our community handles death. Basically, there's a whole page on it. Don't let your emotions get the best of you. It's fucking embarrassing. Embarrassing for you. It's embarrassing to feel for another human being.
Oh, my mic was muted. I'm so dumb. I said, I wonder who wrote this post that she was reading now.
Because you're being a shitty person and causing them to kill themselves. I'm just like, I knew it was bad, but I didn't realize it was this bad. And you know what the fucked up thing is? I know someone on there. Used to be a friend of mine. Who has autistic
calling you
children
out, Manny Cunt.
And posts on there all day long, or at least used to. I don't know. I haven't been on there in a while, but used to post on there every day. That could be your kid. That could be your kid. Actually, she kind of looks like the daughter of someone I know. 19. Yes, very, very messed up. She's a kid. She's mentally ill. She had she's autistic. And she hung herself with a belt. That's how she ended her life. If you are not disturbed by this, if you've ever been to Kiwi Farms or anything like that and contribute to that or are entertained by that, you're disgusting. You're a horrible human being. I mean, come on. Like, that's horrific. Like, you know, like make the whole forum about me. I don't care.
She would
just
love
other
that.
People alone because
she takes these slings and arrows for you gladly. The Pringles can lid might be stuck in her rolls. She can't feel it, but at least she's protected young innocent autistics from being pelted with Pringles can lids for you.
It's scary to me. I've had viewers who have messaged me or emailed me and they're like, you know, just watching your videos prevents me from taking my life. I'm suicidal. And it's like,
I don't believe that for a second. I don't remember her saying that. Oh geez, how embarrassing. How embarrassing to say that.
You know, nobody cares about these people. Like, nobody cares that this person was bullied to death. Anyways, I don't know what I'm gonna do about this. This is ridiculous. You know, people think I'm a bad person. I've never, ever driven someone to kill themselves. So,
I haven't.
I just
either.
Can't. I'm not even in the mood to do a video. I'm not in the mood. I just need time. Like, this is just so disturbing for me. And I had to voice that. And I think she deserves a voice. I think she deserves something, some kind of attention. Instead of just, oh, we're closing the Kiwi Farms page. And read the page. They try to blame her. They try to make her look weak. Oh, it's so gross. It's so gross. I can't imagine how her parents feel. I don't know. I just... 19 years ago, a star was born and was given the name Julie Ayla Patricia.
Well, I just realized. I heard this part before. I was listening to it in the background as I was assembling my clips and writing my notes and shit. Look at her eyes. You can see the reflection of the monitor in her pupils. As she reads the scripted part from her screen.
To Terry Berry. You know, like, Go read the obituary, and if that doesn't bother you, then you're a real asshole. I don't know what else to say about that. You know?
I only see food in those cold orbs.
Guys, I just need some time, because that's just really... The more I look at it, the more I just... I have, like, no faith in humanity left. None. Not much. I know there's good people out there, but this is just so gross, and I'm sure there's a lot worse out there, and that's what's scary. That's what's really scary. Nobody deserves that. Nobody deserves that. There's a difference between trolling and just going on someone's video and or making a comment at somewhere, you know, whatever. But to do this at this level and cause someone to kill themselves, that's just like next level. That's just so wrong.
Be sure to like and subscribe, guys.
This is horrible. I can't even be on here. I can't. It's just bad. Anyways. It's just really horrible. Alright, so I just wanted to bring some awareness to that. I will link everything in the description. I don't really want to give that forum any attention, but I think it's necessary to bring her story to light. I don't know. For me, it's just important to bring awareness to that. I feel really bad for the poor girl, and may she rest in peace.
So if you're not watching this, oh God, I didn't see this part. That's fucking, she didn't use that picture the first time. She had to use the one with the awkward fucking part. Really? Whatever. Rest in peace. Press F, chat. Press F for Julie Terryberry. A star taken before her time. I saw a funny comment. I can't read this name with a straight face. Amberlynn's hair cockroach says, I'm 99% sure she misread people telling her the videos make them suicidal. And I think that is a very fair hypothesis, because yeah, that I don't know how I missed that the first round, because that's legitimately fucking embarrassing that she would say, yeah, that her fucking eating videos kept people from killing themselves. That's bullshit. Oh jeez. There was something I wanted to show you. I don't know why I didn't save this. I apologize. But there were comments on this video before she took it down, of course, saying that they knew. Like, don't you have a thread on that forum? Are you sure you're not using this to try and take down a website making fun of you? And after, like, the response to this, I don't think everybody responding was from the forum. I just think that they were rational people who saw through the bullshit. And they asked her, like, aren't you exploiting this for personal gain? Aren't you trying to rally this as a cause to help yourself? And after a while, she just took it down. And then she made up that bullshit excuse. I'll read it for people who didn't see it. I deleted the video for Julie because I realized that I should have had permission from her family. I wouldn't want to upset them more. I also don't want to give the group any more attention. I only wanted to bring awareness. Well, isn't that the same fucking thing? Whatever. In case you're wondering, Julie Terryberry did not kill herself because of the Kiwi farms. Julie Terryberry was basically an orphan. I think both of her parents were drug addicts or something, and she stayed in the custody of her grandmother. And she had this toxic relationship with her boyfriend. And every time he threatened to leave her, he threatened to leave her, she threatened to kill herself. And eventually he did leave her, and she did kill herself. And that's what it was about. It had nothing to do with the fucking forum. What really, we've had two people who had threads kill themselves. And what annoys me about that is when it happens, we've never been blamed in a suicide note. Nobody gives a shit. You have thousands of people on the forum. Out of those, two people have killed themselves. Statistically, if you have a forum thread, you're less likely to kill yourself than in the general population at this point. But with the reaction from virtue signalers in particular, they like to take what was actually wrong with those people and make it about a forum. In particular, there was Close Gal who set herself on fire, and their manifesto was about homelessness and mental health in the United States. And they had been completely ostracized from the transgender community. Everybody that was trans that we knew hated Chloe. And they then, after kicking them out into the street, after not, they were an asshole to them. They deserved it. They made their own bed, but these people did not give a shit about them until after they died. And then they said they killed themselves because of the Kiwi farms, because they had an investment in trying to take down the site. It happened both times. And in this particular instance, Julie Terryberry was before that. And Julie wasn't trans, so nobody gave a shit except Chantel trying to take down the site. And I think that's pretty fucking despicable, if I do say so myself. Because you're kind of implying that people on an internet forum laughing at weirdos are murderers. And that's fucking sick. Now, where was I?
Hello, foodie beauty.
That's right, we're preventing suicide.
So he put that music on for me, and they just look so bored. And the other girl, ignoring me in the other room, was giggling with her friend. And I'm like, are they laughing at me? Or you know what I mean? Like, it was just so fucking weird.
Is that a cat on a pizza box? He is on a pizza box. What the fuck is this video? Oh, wait, hold up. There was a specific moment in this video that they wanted me to share. Let me find it, hold up. Because in this video, she talks about something a little bit embarrassing. Let me find it. This was specifically requested. Kate, is this it? Sorry, you're gonna have to watch this for now. Oh, I don't know. 370, so that would be 7 minutes to 10 seconds. I got it. I can do math. I can do math, everybody. We got this.
I was going through a goth phase.
Oh, jeez. Oh, this is, okay, this is our first eating video, so I warned you, motherfuckers, she eats gross, she eats fucking nasty, she eats real fucking nasty, aight? So, if you one of those people like me, actually, give me a sec. I need help with this. I don't usually do this, but I need a co-pilot to help me through this stream. This is him. His name is Vodka. And we're going to be going through this together, because I can't fucking handle this shit. You made me spit vodka all over myself. Somebody said Josh is taking his pants off. Fuck you. Fucking asshole. I got fucking shit all over the place now. Oh, jeez. Okay. Let's watch this. Pants are already off.
I love David Bowie. I still do. I would wear, goth clothes. Lacy things, sexy things, big boots. So anyways. I had been drinking by myself. Bad idea.
Oh, you but too, I had huh? been.
And I decided to go online. And I had been talking to this guy who lived in Ottawa.
Okay, I just want to point out, I think if you notice back there, there was a video game or anime or something. And in all the videos that... Oh, shit, I haven't even talked. I hope he doesn't show up in this. I hope he doesn't show up. Okay, there's somebody with her in the background playing video games and sometimes watching anime. We'll get to him. We'll get to him.
Found out he was like worked at a restaurant as like a chef or whatever. He lived with his girlfriend in an upstairs apartment in this old house that her dad owned. His girlfriend's dad. So he was like, you know, we're looking for another girl to fool around with. You know, we want to try having a threesome. She's bisexual.
Oh God. Just so you know, I've not watched this yet.
Okay, you know, so that's cool.
I've just been told it's funny. I'm not enjoying this so far.
And I'm like, I don't have a car. I didn't have a car then. And they didn't. So he's like, well, how much would it be for a taxi? I'll pay for your taxi. I was like, wow, you must really want it badly. You know, there's no women in Ottawa. Population of over 1 million people. Guess not. So, I called the taxi company and I asked, and they said it would be $120. So I said, okay. I told him how much it was. He said, all right, can you leave now? And it was already probably like 8 at night, so it was late. So I said, yeah, it's like, it's a good, you know, hour and a half drive. Give or take. So I call a taxi. And the taxi picks me up. And I just grab a bag with a change of underwear.
Necessary. Oh, God.
When you're going to, you know, when you're going for a threesome.
We'll get to that laugh in a second. At least she closes her mouth. Yeah, this video is not as bad as
And a change of underwear, a pack of condoms.
Not as bad as some of her others.
And a 40-ounce bottle of liquor that was half finished already. Well, a quarter finished or so. And I think I brought a bottle of soda to chase it with. I was planning on drinking in the vehicle. Idiot me. You know, I figure the cab driver's probably male. Can show him cleavage, he'll let me drink. Anyway.
Wait, can we get an instant replay of that?
Anyway.
Guys, look at... Okay, you know, somebody might be listening to this and not... Somebody might be blind. Their eyes might be physically removed. But... If for some reason you can't see what's on the screen right now, her eyes have literally rolled back into her fucking head like she's possessed by some sort of food-loving demon.
Anyway.
What do you mean you can't believe Josh is attracted to the fuck? I'm not a feeder!
Big bag.
I'm not!
Stop slandering me.
This is tell him the address.
Fucking defamation. That serving tray is the plate. You can't see it?
Once we get onto the highway, I opened my bag and took out the bottle. And I looked over at him and he looked at me. And it was a younger cab driver. I think he was from Pakistan. And he looked nervous, but he wanted to be cool the whole ride there, you know. He put on like Tupac on the... He put his Tupac CD in. And when he picked me up, it was like some kind of maybe Indian music or something. I don't know, Pakistani music. So he put on Tupac. Because I was like, I'm going to a party. And, you know, I was like kind of half in the bag. And I'm like, do you mind? Just, I'll be careful. He's like, yeah, just be careful. You can drink, you know? Do not do that. It's against the law. You will get in trouble. So, I started drinking. I asked him to stop at a gas station so I could pee. You know, broke the seal.
Went for a pee. Then I was getting nervous, you know, because I don't like meeting people. And I'm stranded in this big city. The thing was, is that my mom...
I will say this again. If I could watch this story and not see her eat, I would fucking do it. If there were two versions of this, one without eating and one with, we would be watching the one where she's not eating. I don't enjoy this. I don't enjoy this. Why must you besmirch my name? I have such a golden reputation, and you bastards fucking slander me. Sorry, you libel me. Let's get this right. You libel me with your character assassination.
Was, you know, going by herself to see... My aunt lived... Before she lived in Jamaica, she lived in Ottawa, too. And had invited my mom over for, like, a special, you know, just sister's night. So I'm sure my mom was happy to get away. My sister was younger then, and, you know, she wanted probably some alone time. So my mom was up in Ottawa anyway. So I had that in the back of my mind the whole time, like... If anything happens, I can run away there. They probably wouldn't be happy to know that I came up and ruined their thing, but in case, you know? I'm gonna get my
chips. Stop! No!
Okay!
Put the chips away.
Red pepper flakes. Wait,
whoa. Back the fuck up! Whoa, what? What? Look at this! Chat, I command your eyes to feast upon this. What the fuck? Where did she get the second helpings of noodles and fucking Alfredo chicken? What the fuck?
Red pepper flakes. I love red pepper flakes. All right, guys. Sorry for the interruption. Probably like, just get on with the story.
Yeah.
So he drops me off at the house. It's like one of those... older homes. I'm not good with architecture and history, like the, you know, time frames of architecture. But it was probably like, you know, it was a very older house. So they were waiting for me outside, his girlfriend and he and his girlfriend.
You can thank Imspex for this one. Look at her. That's a face of a woman satisfied.
When I got there, they paid the taxi driver. I was like, wow.
No, I don't love it.
He's never spent $120 on me before. I don't think I should have shown up there drunk because I was like, hey, you know, it's probably so annoying. You know? Oh, I got a lot more shrimps, by the way. And more pasta.
Conniption Fit made this one in chat, too, in Discord. That's fucking great.
Oh my god.
I love people.
But anyways, guys. I say that a lot. So, you know, they were kind of, the girlfriend was just kind of like, from the get-go, the girlfriend, I don't know what her problem was. If she either didn't, like, wasn't attracted to me, or she didn't like me, and she was jealous. You know what I mean? Because she would, the whole night, she was, like, looking at me, like, she didn't pay attention to me, she would just give me dirty looks the whole night, and I wasn't getting a vibe at all from her. So I was like, okay, you know, whatever. The guy... I kind of got the same vibe, like, he was kind of just, like, almost like he was going along with what she wanted, you know, he didn't want to make her, this was a new thing for them, whatever, you know.
What a fucking catch for the first time.
Like, either you want to do it, or you don't.
You couldn't hire some Canadian fucking escort, some hot thought? You gotta go for the fucking bargain bin? Jesus Christ, lady, you're killing me. Oh, jeez.
Anyway.
Second shot, y'all.
They were around my age.
Josh has a chance. Fuck you.
He was tall, kind of geeky looking. He wasn't bad. He was very thin.
Some regret starting early.
At the time I wasn't that big. She was heavier than me. Glasses.
Yeah. Holy shit. Somebody just pointed this out. How come she has no ears? Does she have, like, so much fat on, like, the temples of her head that you can't see her ears? Are her ears concave? Does she have a misshapen skull? There are so many possible explanations for this mystery.
No makeup, very plain. So, they're like, well, do you want to go to this local pub for a bit? And I was like, okay. They're like, for a couple drinks? I was like, yeah, more booze? Yeah. But then I was like, oh, we're going to have to walk. And I had the crappiest shoes. They were like big clonker golf boots. So we walked to the pub, and there was like a whole bunch of their friends there, you know. There was like a snobby girl there. She's like, who are you? You know, like, I told her, and she's like, you came all the way in a taxi? Like, she was like, you know. So I had like, I remember getting like a sampler of all these different kinds of beers. I think it was too rowdy for their kind, you know? I was like, woo, let's get shots! And
I don't think I can two times speed on VLC. And everyone probably thought
it was weird, you know? I got the vibe that nobody liked me, pretty much.
No trap.
But I was drunk, so... So I had drinking a lot. I would drink the whole sampler of beers. I had two tequila shots. Everyone had, like, a beer. So they were probably thinking, oh my god, what a lush, you know? Skanky lush. So I'm like, I'm going to go outside for a smoke.
I'm just impressed by how... Like, she's packing down a second serving tray of pasta.
The guy followed me out there.
I am Joshua Moon, and I have a feeder fetish. You paid me $2 to say that.
And
don't clip that. You know,
he's like, I'm sorry if it's not, you know, what exactly you thought it would be. And then out of nowhere, he's like, nice tits, by the way. And I was like, I just felt like really out of place and disgusting. Like, I didn't want to be there. I felt like an object. They made me feel like really low, you know? So I was like, this is fucking boring. This is pathetic. I'm glad you wasted your money, you know?
Whoa.
Anyway, I was stuck.
I was going to say, did they pay her? But then I realized, no, she got paid to come there.
There. So, you know what?
And MSPEX is telling me that this is worth it. So if you're somebody who is doubting, if this is not worth it by the end of it, you can blame MSPEX. You can throw tomatoes at her.
That was only for the one way. That's a little shit, actually. Because I knew that my mom was going up, and I didn't tell her this because I knew she wouldn't say no once I was there. I was kind of just going to, like, show up the next day and be like, can I hitch a ride back home with you? I spent the night at someone's house. So I didn't tell her about it because she would have been like, no, you know, and worried. So that's what happened because I was like, people are going to wonder how I was going to get home, you know? So that's what happened, but I'll get to that point. Anyways, so... You know, he made that... whenever he said nice tits, it kind of sounded like he was trying to make me feel more into
What's
it.
What's the only asset that you have?
I don't know. Anyway.
It's fat girl tits.
He didn't seem like a very sexually forward kind of guy. You know what I mean? So anyways, we end up walking back to their house. We get there. One of her girlfriends, the girl's girlfriends, came back to the place with us. And she's like,
I don't have a feeder fetish, Nicole. I can't.
She goes and lays in her bed, and her friend goes and lays in bed with her. And I'm in the other room listening. I'm like, can you put David Bowie on? And I'm like, you know, do you have anything else to drink? I ended up having more of my bottle that I had left there in my bag. And so he put that music on for me, and they just looked so bored. And the other girl, ignoring me in the other room, was giggling with her friend. And I'm like, are they laughing at me? Or, you know what I mean? Like, it was just so fucking weird. It gets worse. So I'm like, you know what? I'm gonna go in there and see how they act. I go.
Oh God! Wait, is she naked? Wait. She. Oh jeez.
In the room. The minute I get in there, they stop giggling and they look at me. And I'm like, do you mind if I get in bed with you guys? So I get in bed, and the girl like kind of just shrinks away. And then after a few minutes, she's like, I think I'm just going to go to bed. So I'm like, okay. She's like, do you mind hitting the light when you leave the room? I'm like, you invited me here. You paid $120 for me to get here. And you're acting like a total bitch. Like, what's your problem? You know?
Oh my God.
And then the guy was like, yeah, I think I'm just going to go to bed. Sorry. We're just really tired, you know? I was like, okay. So he's like, here, I'll set you up your own little space. Like, he was nice.
How does this get worse?
And I remember trying
this is
to
so
sleep
awkward.
And looking out the window, and everything was spinning. Like, it was just spinning and spinning and spinning and spinning. And oh my God.
Yeah.
So I must have fallen asleep. I woke up early the next morning. Naturally, I woke up to the feeling of having to be sick. I'm like, oh shit. I don't even know if I don't even know where the bathroom is. You know, I hadn't taken note. So I ran like through the hall, little hall, and it was a small bathroom apartment. So their bedroom was right there beside the bathroom. I'm like, they're gonna hear everything. I find the bathroom. Get on my knees, start doing my thing. And
why is she throwing up?
This is gross, guys. Warning you if you're grossed out. You can't say I didn't warn
oh,
you.
Oh,
so
no.
Don't wait for me later. Turn
oh,
away.
Oh, no.
3 seconds.
Oh, no.
So it comes out both ends. And a G-string.
Oh, holy shit. Third shot. Okay, so fat bitch goes to have a threesome, didn't have a threesome, slipped on the couch, is now sick, throwing up and hunched over, I guess on her belly, throwing up into a toilet, wearing a G-string, shitting herself. Oh no.
The barf goes projectile all over their wall. The poop goes all over their floor. No towels, no paper towel anywhere in the bathroom, no toilet paper. So, at this point, I was like panicking. But they didn't wake up, they were still sleeping somehow. I didn't hear any movement. I didn't know what to do. I took my G-string off.
Oh, please tell me she just leaves.
Cleaned up with some socks and some clothes I had in my bag. You know, I think I had a sweater or something in there. Anyway, it was disgusting. And I smelled bad.
Yeah, no shit, you just shit.
And I was like, shit, you know? I had no money.
She's stuck. She has to tell them now. She has to confront these people.
I called the taxi. And I took it to my aunt's house.
Well, hold up.
I was banking on the hopes that...
Did she leave with... She left without telling them.
My mom would pay for the taxi.
She snuck out after shitting on their floor.
So I didn't have a cell phone then either. You know? So... I get there, I'm like, tell the cab, I'm going to be right back. I have to get the money. I knock on the door, no answer. I'm like, shit. I knock on the door again. You know, and then I see somebody peep through the peephole. And my aunt's like, it's Cutie. What the hell? So they answer the door. They look at me. And they're like, you smell bad. What the hell? So I explain everything. I started crying. My mom was, they were both livid. They were mad at me for doing that. Which I don't blame them. So, like I said, I was a little shit sometimes. So she paid the cab. I went in, I had a shower, had something to eat, had something to drink. Oh, I felt so good just being there. You know what I mean?
She shit on those people's floor and did. She got to a cab she could not afford and went to
it. Eventually, my mom got over it, but she was mad. She could have been killed, blah, blah, blah. Which is true.
I'd have fucking killed this bitch if she shit on my floor.
So anyways, guys, I'm pretty full. Whew.
I would fucking hope so. That's the second serving tray.
Cooking it with the flour and the low-fat milk makes it...
Is that your segue from the shitting yourself story?
It's easier to digest.
Oh, hey guys, the lighting is
oh,
bad.
Oh, God! I didn't expect this.
I'm editing this video, and I've noticed that I did not explain what happened after. So you guys are probably like, what the hell? So,
She got distracted.
I don't want to leave you guys hanging, so I just want to say... that, you know, I snuck out of the house and to my aunt's after that ordeal with my, you know, being sick, without waking them up. What happened after when I went home, I never heard from them again. I never heard from him again. So I'm assuming they found my mess and just were like, screw this chick. I'm not messaging her anymore. So that's probably what happened.
So anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed that. And please check out Candy's video. I'm sure hers is delicious. Show her some love. And please listen to her story. I'm sure she has a similar story to tell as well. So yeah, so check it out. And again, thank you guys so much for watching and commenting and liking and subscribing. Bye, guys. Bye, foodie beauties.
I'm in physical pain. I'm just imagining her hunched over on her all fours in front of the toilet. And she said she had a G-string on when she was shitting herself. So I'm just imagining this spray coming out in like two separate streams in different directions, like bifocal shitting. So Irver Mom sent a GIF, which I think is funny. Oh, well, I can't show this because it's not actually a GIF, it's a webm. That is staggering. I might as well just end the fucking stream there. That's it. I should have saved that for fucking last. I hadn't seen that. I hadn't seen that before. M Specs was just like, no, it's fucking funny. It's fucking funny. You gotta watch it. You gotta watch it. So I'm like, okay, whatever. I need a good video of her eating. So I guess I'll pop this on to show people what it's like when she's eating. And no, I get a story about her going to have a threesome and not having sex at all because people are physically revolted by her. And then she goes into the bathroom the morning after and just dumps ass. This fucking brat pug just fucking dumps ass on their fucking floor. Oh my god. Where do I go from here? Once again, just in case you're wondering, this is the address that you send your litigation to, Chantal. This is where you send it to. In case you opt to sue me. For dragging you over the fucking coals. Oh my god. Alright, let me get some water. I think I'm gonna die. Jesus fucking Christ, my head hurts. I was dying. I can't remember the last time I lasted that hard. Jerking it off can dehydrate you. Yeah. Well, let me read chat. People paid money for me. People enjoyed that story, apparently. Josh, I'm a bit chubby. Can you? And I want you to feed me. I can't do that. I can't feed people. I'm not a feeder. I'm sorry. Do you also have a hog feeder bin that you eat out of? No, I do not. I just eat borscht out of a bowl like a normal person. I'm not using VLC, so I can't speed it up that way. Yes, Josh, this is your future wife. No. I'll take Tub Girl over her any day. That's fucking fair. You know, Tub Girl, when Tub Girl shits herself, she shits herself in a tub where cleanup is easy and not all over the fucking floor where you have to... Oh, my God. Now that her picture is up on the screen, I'm just thinking of her fucking cleaning the bathroom floor with goddamn socks. And she said she left a mess. Like, she made it sound like she cleaned it up and was tidy about it, but no, she fucking left a mess. Because she said it after the fact, when she was in the bed and had forgotten her story. Oh my God. Seen them Cortez ludes yet? I've seen, like, her nipples in the reflection, but that's it. Alright, let's move on. I don't want to get stuck reading super chats. It's going to get boring. I left this as like a little fucking footnote at the bottom. She likes to claim that every man that ever looks at her is she calls them lovers. Like anytime anybody looks at her and she thinks that they're into her, she calls them a lover. And she talks constantly about how men are into her because they're staring at her. She's catching men looking at her in public. And apparently it doesn't occur to her that she's a proper fucking brat pug. And people are legitimately frightened by her physical appearance. But I want to make this perfectly clear. You know, chat's taking the piss. I'm not a feeder. I'm not into women that shit all over the fucking floor in two fountains of poo. Splashing all over the place, getting everything nice and shitty. Not into that. I'm not being sarcastic. That isn't fucking sarcasm. I not know. Most of the people that make like watching videos of just shitting on her, as opposed to shitting on the bathroom floor, are women. So this might be like the first man to ever make a video making fun of her, but she went to somebody's house and shit on their floor. That's funny. That's actually fucking hysterical. That is unironically fucking funny. And it's laughing that that's not hitting on you. Okay, the other lie that she told. You know, Amberlynn, I draw comparisons to her, and it's a fair comparison to make. But Amberlynn, you know, has all these little white lies that she likes to tell. With Chantel, she's more boring. She's unemployed for one, and she's been in a consistent relationship, so it's not broken up into sagas based on what person she's with. But she did lie about having a 1-year contract at a mental hospital. She worked secretary at a mental hospital for a year, and she said that it was just a contract to cover somebody's maternity leave. But in truth, she was fired. So. Not on her Christmas list right now, so I get to just gonna throw that in there. It doesn't compare to her shitting all over the fucking floor. But it's the best that I can do right now. Alright. It's time we get to the hero, to the tragic victim of this story. A man. You know, it's not all just Chantal shitting all over the floor. It is There's another person. I mentioned the guy playing anime. Alright. Let me introduce you to player two.
Hello, foodie beauties.
Hey guys, welcome to Cooking with BB. Today we're going to be making Senegalese
BB. That's a cute name for a boyfriend, I guess.
And it is a butter stew like type sauce. So what you're gonna need for this, and there's so many different kinds of recipes and ways to make this, but this is the way.
Yes,
make
if you've been watching my streams about one. This, you can. You've already seen this so video. This isn't new. Nah, you will suffer.
Carrots,
you will suffer.
Three carrots chopped up. Some scotch.
We're watching this.
There's scotch bonnet peppers.
There are lots of people watching. There's like 1,500 fucking people watching.
All natural peanut butter.
Watching this. So we're gonna show. We're gonna introduce a whole new generation of sadness into the world.
I prefer the original, but I accidentally picked up a Italian.
How far are we into this?
Some black pepper, two potatoes.
About a minute. It's coming up.
I'm probably not gonna use all of this.
It's coming up.
I'm probably gonna use half of onion. It could be any type of onion. And I'm gonna use three boneless, skinless chicken breasts. Now, most people who make this dish use bone-in, but this is just the chicken I have on hand right now.
The camera is slowly panning
over.
And we're
going to use two cubes
in this direction. I wonder.
Which is just like.
I wonder what is at the far end.
Stock cube.
What's coming up?
You can get these in African or Caribbean stores, I think. I know in African stores for sure you can. African grocery store. And I'm going to use this to grind
the cuck feeder. Fuck you.
And we're going to use some peanut oil to, you know, just... peanut oil is what we always use for this type of dish. So these are the ingredients you're going to need for that. So let's get cooking.
There he is!
Oh, God.
There's our boy.
Okay, so first step we do is we add the chicken breast. This is like cooking ASMR. On medium high heat in the peanut oil, and we're gonna cook it on both sides until it's brown, right, babe?
Yeah. Let me tell you how much my man BB likes to be filmed for these fucking vlogs.
So we're just gonna cook this and then eat it. And I'll be back when
I mentioned video games and anime. You weren't expecting this.
Ooh, yum. Look how brown those chicken baby breasts are getting. And see the little at the bottom, that's all flavored down there. I know it looks like a lot of
fried chicken. An all American dish.
The chicken are mixing with that.
Can we just watch Kay's cooking and said no.
I wish you could smell this place right now. It smells good.
BBC? Okay. This never aired on the BBC. What are you talking about?
Thanks for cooking.
He cooks with the enthusiasm of a prison chef.
We're almost done. Are we going to need 2 cans of tomato paste? Now we're just going to add the chopped onions. The chicken. He did drain out a little bit of the oil. Oh, it smells so good. There's the minced garlic there on the in the jar I'll put in. The garlic there in the jar.
He has to work his hands bloody. He's in the kitchen every day, slaving over a hot stove. For 2 serving trays of this shit. All he's thinking, okay, let's be serious. Again, this is not a racist stream and this is not a bully stream, okay? Everything I'm saying is out of love for my man BB, because he busts his fucking ass. He does more than I ever did for a fucking visa. BB is not out the hood. He's from Senegal. Let me just pause this for a moment, give you guys some reprieve, and let's look up what the fuck Senegal is. Senegal. Find it on the maps. This is Western Africa. This is fucking poor. Legit fucking poor place. Yeah, like, it has some resort towns for tourists and shit, because it's right on the fucking coast, you know. It's got some beautiful beaches in Africa and shit. But this is a poor, poor fucking place. And, you know, these are all tourist pictures and shit. I did see some pictures that were out of the fucking, like, the slums. And the slums are what you would expect from, like Liberia or some shit. Like, they're really bad. I think this is a more typical, like, roadside in Senegal. It's just a really poor fucking place. And, again, Chantal's in Canada. She's 34 now. They've been together for 6 years. He has a permanent residence visa. And he just sticks it through with her. There we go. This is more slummy. It's just, yeah, it's real fucking poor. So my man, I feel for him. I feel for my man BB, okay? Because he busts his ass to fucking earn his residence visa with this woman who has undoubtedly shit in two different directions at least once in his house. I'm going to guarantee you that this has happened at least once in his house. All right, just a little detour on the side to show you what BB would go back to if he gave up.
Not a great cameraman.
If he gave in to the strife.
Add a little bit of minced garlic to your taste. Everything is to your taste. I mean, you can add as many onions, as much garlic, as much everything you want, pretty much, of any of these ingredients. I'm gonna go chop the potatoes and carrots. School's at.
Oh, I have breaking news from MPEX. MPEX would like you guys to know that BB once looked in her room, looked in one of their closets, and he found 10 pizza boxes that she had hidden in the closet. I can imagine his. I can only imagine what his face would look like upon discovering those pizza boxes. But I guarantee you, it would be somewhat similar to how it looks all the fucking time. This dull look of utter contempt and depression. All right, I want you guys to pay attention. If you happen to have your eyes on the screen. Pay attention to her master cooking technique, her cutting technique. She's basically fucking Emeril Lagasse.
Peel them. Do I need to peel the potatoes?
Just keep your eyes on those hands.
So we're gonna chop. The good thing about mafé is you can have big chunks of vegetables, like. Usually they put just big chunks of vegetables. You don't have to cut them too small. Because you want them to withstand the cooking, you know? The potatoes. Oh, right there. So he's going to put the lid just to let everything cook together for now. And.
Again, look at her cutting technique if you can.
So
it's so hard to describe it. She cuts like she's wielding a fucking battle axe in World of Warcraft. Like her technique with vegetables indicates she has never once in her life prepared an actual meal.
Cooperation makes it happen. Cooperation, working together, dig it. Did you guys ever watch that on Sesame Street? Okay.
Oh yeah, she kind of realizes at some point that BB not fucking talking at all is like,
be careful with big
like awful, just depressing. So she
we'll be back, guys.
She starts That's to make it. Noises and shit for no reason.
All right, so we're just gonna add some jumbo.
And you can tell seasoning. This is especially the part. And again, it's really hard if you're just listening to kind of convey this.
Just some of it.
BB never smiles. Like when she talks to him and she makes jokes and she giggles and stuff. His reaction is none.
There's so many different ways. I mean,
the only thing I can read from his face, from his reaction, is that her being there and being 400 plus pounds and 5 foot one is she's taking up all his fucking space. They have a small kitchen and he's trying to cook, you know, a meal for two families.
We're gonna put the lid on for a few minutes.
And she's just in his fucking space. And every time she talks to him, you can tell. He just wishes she'd get the camera out of his face and get out of the kitchen.
Yeah. Just anything. This is my kitchen!
Why the peanut butter? Okay, I'll pull it up for you guys.
Fruit flies. But, you know. Yes. Oh, and BB Jeans used the litter box. How nice.
Oh god, the fucking laugh she does is awful.
Bee. Hi, Bee! Look at this pretty girl, everybody. BB Jeans. BB Jeans. BB Jeans. And now he's mixing. Is that the whole thing?
Okay. Yeah. And for people wondering, What he's preparing is a dish called mafa. It is a Senegal traditional meal, and it uses peanuts. It's a sort of peanut soup that's usually served over rice. So that's what he's trying to make.
It's gonna be acidy, because tomato paste is really acidy. So, but some people really like really tomato-y things. We don't like the really acidy tomato taste too much. So, but cooking it the way we're gonna cook it here will help reduce some of that acid. So. Oh yeah, baby. And it's gonna mix with all the oils. So I'm just gonna mix it around.
BB Run, free my man BB. Run, BB, run. There's so much. You have so much to live for, BB.
Looks good, babe. Adding more water.
Looks good, baby. Yes, female companion. It does indeed look appetizing. Except you gotta make it more hood. You gotta make it more Afrikaans.
Hey Sam, are you a big boy or are you a big girl? No one knows. What are you? A big boy, big boy.
Also, I mentioned her cats earlier. She talks to her cats like a fucking insane person. She doesn't use like the baby voice. She uses the voice of the little girl from The Exorcism with the demonic possession. He has so much contempt.
What are you doing? It's weird being on camera, isn't it? I love it.
He has so much contempt.
You know, some people just don't like being on camera, but I'm not one of those. There's a fruit fly. See it, guys? Let's name it. Babe, we name the bugs in our house. We always name the bugs in our house. Do you like the wreath on my door, guys?
BB, it's not worth it. You had a family. You had a family in Senegal.
All year, all seasons.
It was poor, but it was home.
I'm one of those people that don't take things down. So, yeah. So it's just cooking away, getting ready to add those veggies. Oh, yeah. So, we're just putting the veggies in. BB is peeling the potatoes because he does not like the peel on potatoes. But I do. I don't mind. But I guess in this dish, it's better without the peel.
See, I mentioned this was a not a racist stream. And I see many people in chat who are developing, many racist people in chat who are developing connections and empathy for our brother here, who is exactly like us. And you guys looking at this shit understand the pain.
But again, it's
and your racism is dissolving away through this shared agony.
Hi, Sam. Sam.
Oh, hi.
He's swiper right now.
Oh, big boy. Are you a big boy? Are you a big boy? Or are you a big girl? Nobody knows, do they? Nobody knows.
That's right, I'm fixing racism.
Guys, I always get distracted by cats. I'm a crazy cat lady, what can I say? So, we've added the veggies. We're going to add more water to cover the veggies. You can add as much water as you like. It depends how soupy you like your mafé. We like ours more.
Josh wants BB to leave her so we can slide into the feeding room. I don't think so.
We poked holes all throughout.
I don't need a Canadian passport. That ain't happening.
Very simple dish, but it's very delicious.
Does she ever shut up? This is how my GF's mom acts. Yeah, she fills every second of dead air with nonstop fucking babbling. Fucking psycho babble.
So put enough water at least to cover the veggies and cook them, you know? So now we just let this cook for... You're going to put the water and cover it and let it cook until the vegetables are tender. And then you're going to come back and put the peanut butter. Okay, we're getting ready to add the PB&J. No, just the PB.
Oh, look at that.
That's my new favorite voice, guys. Oh... Demonic. Perfect for Halloween.
Yeah.
Get out of the fucking kitchen. He's trying to feed you.
Oh, and in the meantime,
and you make it, you prolong his suffering.
Jasmine rice.
He just wants to cook.
That is our favorite rice.
He wants to to smell the smells of the food of his homeland and reminisce when he was surrounded by family and not strange foreign white women who never shut the fuck up.
Creamy goodness. I have not eaten since I had some leftover of that lentil lasagna with some side salad. 2 squares of dark chocolate, and that's it. I'm saving my calories for this meal. Yum yum. So I think you just put a couple of tablespoons. Are you gonna add more water? And add, I think we've added about three cups of water so far. So he's gonna add probably about another cup. We just eyeball. We really don't measure things. So about 4 cups of water total. And then we're just gonna cover the stuff up, guys, and let it cook. We're gonna reduce the heat and let it cook.
Yeah.
For about, I'd say about what, 20 minutes? Give or take.
Yeah.
You'll know when it's ready. The oil will separate on the top.
I just want this agony I mean to be that. Uncut.
I'll show you when it's ready, guys.
I want you guys to feel it.
It's splattered everywhere, but it's done. So we're just gonna skim a little bit of the oil off the top. Once you stir it in,
it's a lot of oil.
You know, it mixes, but now we're gonna eat, guys. Hi, guys.
Look at him.
We are going to eat this delicious.
BB, you had a family. It wasn't worth it. It wasn't worth it, BB. Oh no.
This mafe. Look at that. Don't you want a bite? And the peppers are just the garnish, but they were cooking in the sauce. So, and I have string beans, pickles, and cherry bush. Okay, so the cats are being bad. So traditionally in Senegal and in other African countries too, you eat off the same big plate.
Yeah.
Like there's one big plate of food made okay. for the whole family. And for
this is important to the lore. Again, just in case you're listening to this and not watching it. They have taken this meal, which is like a really chunky peanut kind of soup, and they've put it over rice, and she's explaining that in Senegal, the family eats off the serving tray. So everybody gets together, and they eat off the same plate. And the video is them sitting next to each other, eating off the same plate. BB happens to have a spoon. Chantal happens to have a serving spoon that you would cook with. And I will narrate the progress of this plate as we go on.
They're so generous and nice. And everybody just eats, you know? But if I go into your spot, is that rude?
Yes.
Oh, also, Chantal's gotten a fucking side of pickles. She's got like a jar of pickles on the stand. I don't know why. I guess she needs some fucking pickles. Yeah. That's sesame oil, by the way. Yeah, this is a very unflattering angle for Chantal. Look how fucking big she is. Holy shit. Yeah, take this fucking home-cooked Senegalese meal and douse it in fucking sriracha ketchup.
Is it good?
Let's try. BB's just, like, relegated. He's, like, pinned into his corner of the plate. She's spilling shit all over the fucking table.
It's hot.
It's got habanero on it. Of course it's fucking hot. He wants a little bit of that sesame oil too, though. BB likes sesame seed oil. It's not all bad.
You guys, I wish you could
Phoebe's just wondering what his sisters are up to, what his mom's up to. Hoping she's all right. Hoping she has enough food right now back in the village.
Yeah, if you have any is mafe Senegalese dish or is it from another place? It's West African, right?
Narrating a man dying by food is not feeding fetish. It's just I'm just doing a public service announcement for my man BB.
Peanut. So Senegal has peanuts?
Yeah. A country that have a lot of peanut develop a way to cook food. Some of them are
not BB just wants to go home to his family but has to spend all his money on food to preserve his own safety. Else he will be one of the many devoured. You're making this dark. I'm just taking it rationally. I don't want to think about BB getting fucking bored. I'm not mentally capable of dealing with that. Oh god, you gave me a dark thought.
Do you know what they do different than this one?
Maybe they will put more water.
But in Senegal, you very rarely eat your chicken without bones, right?
What?
Like you would use chicken with the bone in.
Yeah, because the chicken is cooked there, it's still there. And even if you come with.
I hurt myself today.
Even if you come with.
To see if I still feel. I focus on the pain.
Doesn't matter.
The only thing that's real.
Yeah, but not everybody. They have chicken to sell.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
But she doesn't have her own chickens like for eggs and things?
No, not for eggs.
That's why he puts the habaneros on it. He needs the pain to remind himself that he exists. He's still tethered to this plane of misery.
The only thing you buy for the month is probably rice, sugar, oil, stuff like that.
The Johnny Cash one's better than the fucking Nine Inch Nails one. Even Trent Reznor says that. Yeah, you can hear the anime music in the background. BB, if you look at him, if you watch him, he'll sometimes glance over her shoulder and look at the television because his animes are on. BB's going to go back to Africa with nothing but the shirt on his back and a entire season of anime.
It might go bad when there is no electricity.
Yeah. I see. Whenever? Do you remember? When's the first time I ate this here? You told me about it.
Phoebe puts just like a little dab of that shit in the corner. She like sprays all over the fucking place.
We made it one night, and ever since then, I've been in love with Mafe. Like,
He actually chooses food. Yes, he does. He doesn't get much of it. He has to enjoy it.
Can you tell them the little riddle about Mafe makes you fart?
BB's fattening her up like Hansel and Gretel. We can only hope.
Yeah.
I don't know, it doesn't...
No eye contact. Anime is what gets him through the day. BB sits on the sofa and he watches like anime girls go through their school day. And he's just like, God, I wish that was me.
Ooh, spicy. So delicious. You really made it well.
Yeah. You can get add gumbo.
Gumbo?
If you like gumbo.
Gumbo is okra.
okra.
Yeah, you can. I think we had some frozen okra. I wish we would have added some.
Alright, I think this is the appropriate time to cut this off. Yeah, you just see him checking anime every so often. There's something I want to say, because MSPEX wants to talk, and I don't think there's anything particularly interesting that happens after this. You can just check. I'll skip through it again so you can see. Watch the plate if you can. And check the progress. I like how there's a visible delineation to see who's making more progress on the food. And not only is she completely stomping him in the progress made during the actual eating of the food, she's taking breaks to eat some of those fucking dill pickles. Just, they're like road bumps. They're fucking speed blocks to try and slow her ass down. And not fucking working. Feeling severe. Look at his face. Hashtag winning. He just wants to watch his fucking animes. He doesn't want to be on camera. She's starving him. Okay. So I should mention this. Let me just go ahead and open up Firefox, right? And I'm going to go find her channel real quick. Alright, we go to her videos, right? We go, so, and this is sorted by newest, thank God. So 2 weeks ago, I think a little bit more than that, she posted a video saying BB's leaving. Now this is a clickbait title. He's just going back to Senegal to be with his family. Over Christmas, I guess. And I think she says in that, it's only meant to be a week, but he is yet to appear in any of the subsequent videos. And from what I understand, because this is also 2 weeks ago, and she's making a video calling saying being okay with being alone. And I think she's talking about how BB left behind like his sister to babysit her while he was gone. I'm pretty sure he's not coming back. I think he's gone, guys. I think he made it. I think he's gone. I think he's free. I don't know for sure, because, you know, even if that were the case, she would keep it secret. But this is just between me and you guys, but I've received this transmission from Senegal. And I think there might be a little bit of this going on somewhere.
Oh. Traditional drums,
grab some music.
Crunk of the hip-hop MCs and sounds of neighboring countries shape movement on the city streets. Over the next half hour,
freedom.
We're on a journey to discover how traditional dance is being kept alive.
Godspeed, BB.
Incubating something new.
May you find what you're looking for on the other side.
This is street dance in Senegal.
All right. I'm done with the dancing. Enough dancing. Stop the dancing. I do need to cut my audio on. Cut Firefox off. On air, foreground. Discord. That can work. Yes, it is. M's, your mic's not working, M's. M's, are you okay?
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay.
Did you need to correct the record?
I just wanted to give some more info on a few things that you talked about.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so just some interesting facts. You showed a picture, like a side-by-side picture earlier of like her degeneration. Mm-hmm. Well, I just wanted to say, it's funny, the picture on the right of that is actually when she got a new camera, and it was, she said it was too HD, and because it showed her looking fucking horrific, and she never used it again. And
well, that's also, that's a thing. Like, they have to digitally de-age celebrities and shit now. But yeah, you can tell. Like, you can see, like, her skin is just awful.
Yeah, I know. It's fucking horrible. And
I mean, I would agree with her. That is too HD. That's a bit too close for comfort.
It's too HD because it exposes how bad her skin really is.
Well, it's kind of shocking because isn't she supposed to be a makeup expert?
I wouldn't say expert, but I mean, she thinks she's good at makeup.
Well, she started her channel to be about makeup before she realized she could make money off men wanting to see her eat herself to death.
Yeah. Okay, and then another thing, you talked about, she left a comment on a video about someone who killed themselves.
Yes.
That guy was actually Ricardo Lopez, the Bjork stalker. And he uploaded a, like, last video on YouTube that I think it's still on YouTube. You can find it, but it's just, like, you can clearly see how mentally ill he is. And so that's where that comment is from.
Oh, so she's making fun of the mentally handicapped. That's detestable. Nobody should do that.
No, they really shouldn't.
So, yeah. Well, I mean, that's even worse, because, I mean, I don't know, is she, like, a Bjork fan? Is that a thing?
I don't know, probably.
All right, well, thank you for letting me know.
Yeah.
Was that it?
And, well, I have so much shit I could say about Chantel that you didn't even touch on.
Well, I'm not even done. I still got shit. What's the interesting thing that you can think of?
Well, I feel like you need to talk about the end of her relationship with Pete.
Oh, I wrote that down. I did not bring it up. She cheated on him. He was a fiance for
like 7 years.
Yeah, 6 or 7 years, and she cheated on him with BB, and
well,
right?
Okay, so she will like fudge her story on this. See, this is the thing. You talked about how like Chantel doesn't lie the way Amber does, like white lies, but she really does. You have to watch like a lot of her videos over time where she'll talk about like the same things over and over, and you like start noticing the inconsistencies in what she says, because I think like she's embarrassed about some of this shit, but like she knows she gets the views for talking about it, so she'll try
for
to
talking
punch
about
some
shitting
of it.
In two directions.
Oh my god. She has so many stories about like throwing up.
Well,
or shitting herself.
Hold up, don't spoil it. I still have those TMI videos to go over.
That's not even all of them that I put up there. Like, she has stories from when she was a kid. But yeah, so she, towards like the end of her relationship with Pete's, but while they were still together, she got on Plenty of Fish and started like, you know, looking for attention. And she hooked up with like two other guys. One was from Rwanda, and one was from Nigeria. And she said the Nigerian guy, like, hit her or something. I don't really care.
Sorry, that's awful. That's bad. You can't laugh at that.
But then after that, she got, like, together with BB and, like, finally broke up with her, with Pete, who she's still friends with. And I wouldn't be surprised if they're hooking up now, to be honest.
What, the ex-husband? That's really sad. He gets back with her. He's fucking gross.
Well, you would have to watch a video with him. Like, you can tell that he's autistic. And just seems like a kind of weird, lonely dude, so.
Well, I put up a thing. I mentioned, the first time I saw that video, I mentioned, how she was dressed up all fancy and he's just wearing like this like plain hoodie. And I made the joke, is he like a fucking house elf? If she gives him clothes, does he get his visa? Can he leave? So
poor BB.
Yeah.
I would love to know the real timeline on him and his residency, because I don't fully believe what Chantel says about it. We had somebody in her thread, someone from Canada, basically break down the entire process of getting permanent residency in Canada. And she made it sound like it could have just happened like fairly recently. So it wouldn't surprise me if he like left Chantel soon. If he's just like,
no, because he got his visa.
To Senegal. I'm getting my shit together. Yeah.
Well, I don't. Oh, he works. Oh, I didn't mention he works as a security guard, so he does have his own income. He could have been. He could have been sticking cash away in secret places.
Yeah, he's. Well, Chantel doesn't have income aside from whatever she makes from YouTube, which probably isn't that much.
I don't know. People can make a lot. Like that fucking Wings of Redemption guy, the fat guy I played at the start of the video. He still makes like $600 a month off videos he made years ago. So the money can be lucrative if you're in the right thing. And like with Amber Lynn, I opened her video up to play it, and I can only, for technical reasons, I can only record Firefox. I can't record Chrome. And on Firefox, I didn't have ad blocker installed. I open up Amber Lynn's video in Firefox without ad blocker, and it was like a 10-minute video with 10 different ad breaks. And I'm just like, just like, how many people actually sit through all that shit? Because that's fucking impressive.
Yeah, Chantel tries her hardest to stick in ads and stuff, but she doesn't have as many subscribers or get as many views as Amber, so.
That's because Amber is more interesting. Chantel is just like, does she have like a Patreon?
She used to. Well, she shut it down at some point, but then she has one up and she has like one patron on it, but she never talks about it or anything.
That's strange. Because I think people were talking about how she was literally just a feeder. Like she was doing the food shit.
Well, yeah. The thing about Chantel is that even compared to Amber Lynn, Chantel is just like fucking sick. Like she is physically, mentally, emotionally ill. And like a cluster B. Just clusterfuck of a human being.
People want a Patreon for BB to help him out.
Yeah, hell yeah, free BB. Get him that money. He needs it. Fully get away from her.
We're gonna open a 501c3 charity called the BB Foundation.
Go fund me for BB.
And we're gonna send money back to Africa to build homes for people and feed them and feed them mafe or whatever.
Yeah, Chantel is just inconsistent with everything she does. She has no willpower, and she tries to hide that from people. So she'll do like lies about.
Oh, I didn't get to mention. She cheated on that guy, the fiance, with BB, right?
She's.
So BB,
she's tried to say before that like they were like their relationship was basically over, but then she's also said that. She's been asked, like, so you cheated on your ex? And she was like, yep.
BB, you know, I am being dead serious, chat. I have a life lesson for you. You know who else got with a woman that he cheated on his wife with? Robert Chandler, Christian Weston Chandler's father, got with Barb, the worst woman to ever be born ever in the history of the fucking world. Cheated on his wife for that. And Bob Chandler, a man who has patents and fucking like rubber engineering, who has actual patents in his name, cheated with the most disgusting barfly ever, conceived Christian Weston Chandler, and died being devoured by bedbugs in a house filled with horde, which burned down after he died. His garden is overrun with weeds and shit. Do not cheat. You will be BB. You will be Robert Chandler. You will pay for your sins. God watches you. And he has wrath. He has wrath for those that cheat. It's just my biblical prophecy.
For those that
prophecy.
Cheat and those who destroy people's bathrooms and then flee the scene.
I think that's like the eighth circle of hell is reserved for people who shit all over somebody else's bathroom. And it, like, she didn't even touch on the vomit. You know there was
no.
You know there was vomit.
Well, did you
there.
Listen to her? What she said? She said there was no toilet paper.
Yeah, so she used her socks. So she just smeared it around
her socks
the fucking.
In a sweater,
yeah, I'm sure that
which
there
probably
was.
Probably just made it worse.
There was shit and vomit caked into like the grout around the tiles.
And then, like, she cleaned it so inadequately that when she gets to her fucking aunt's house, the first thing they say is, like, girl, you smell like shit. It's like, well, it's an awkward story. I kind of shit all over myself and over somebody's bathroom. You know, the cab guy was, I bet you the fucking cab guy had the AC blasting and he rolled down the fucking windows.
Like, yeah, and you noticed she didn't say anything about, like, the cab guy. He was probably, like, I need this money. Like, I need so this money.
I got my family back in Senegal. I got to send them a fucking check so they can eat. Like,
in the car and he was like, oh shit, it's too late.
I can't say get the fuck out, you smell like shit now. Like, I'm gonna get a bad Uber review. That's gonna be...
I was watching chat when you were watching that and I saw people like, this is boring, blah, blah. I'm like, just wait.
I hadn't seen that before. I had to strengthen confidence in people and be like, she says it's funny, so we gotta stick through it.
I don't think I ever told you it was, like, funny. I told you it was really gross, but also, like, the most amazing thing she's ever uploaded.
Yeah, you said it was your favorite thing she's ever uploaded. But the thing is that when you describe it as gross, I'm just thinking, like, oh, the threesome is going to be really disgusting. She's going to describe sex or something.
She has a video where she, like, has a threesome that was also disgusting for different reasons. I put that in backstage, too. It's one of the last ones.
But she doesn't shit all over the bathroom in that one, so it's not as funny?
No. No, it's gross for a different reason.
All right. Well, I do want to watch another video. I'm tempted. I want to show people how aggravating as fuck she is. And I'm tempted to play two different videos of her, just like, one's a mega clip and the other is a video that she uploaded where she's just grating as fuck.
What video is it?
I'll tell you in the back room or the backstage thing. Do you have a request? I need the TMI video. I don't have that one downloaded. I need that one though.
Which one?
The one with the sticking. Okay. You know what I mean? I need that one.
I don't know what you mean.
I'll tell you. I will describe it. But I need that one. Okay. I think you timestamped it. I think it's fine. Because trust me, people definitely want to hear this. Especially if you're eating. You'll want to hear this. All right. I'm going to play that one in a bit. But thank you. If you want to come on again, just let me know.
Okay.
Wait. Foreground. Cut off Discord. Okay. It's just me and you again, my friend. We're back. We're back at it again. Okay, I'm just gonna annoy the fuck out of everybody. Give me a second. I want to make sure that you hate me by the end of this.
Okay, you guys, today you watch so. No, kitty, that's a bad.
I want to say that her impression is awful, but Her cosplay is fucking spot on. You just gotta give her the little hat and the parka. And just dead ringer. Look at that.
Kitty! Do you guys? I'm going home. I love cheesy poofs. We love cheesy poofs.
Okay, butters.
Oh, hamburgers. I love apples. Lululu. You love apples.
I wanna point this out. I've seen this person both in my chat and in different Amberlynn and Chantal videos of somebody named O Hamburgers who has this exact picture of Butters doing looking into here. And I wanna give a big shout out to O Hamburgers. Who will definitely see their favorite character of South Park be portrayed in the worst possible fucking way.
I really suck. Okay, so I'm going to do a couple impersonations from The Simpsons.
I have to annoy more people. I made a little list of
people I want
to
try doing, so that's why I keep looking at. Okay, Krusty the Clown actually is the only Simpsons impersonation I'm going to do, so I'm sure you all know who Krusty the Clown is. If not, check him out. It's a clown from The Simpsons.
Oh, God.
So, okay. I'm going to impersonate his laugh.
Oh, no.
This is going to be hard because he has a very iconic laugh.
Oh, that's legit fucking terrifying.
Oh, Lord. I need someone to pay attention to me. All right, Donald Trump. This is my impersonation of Donald Trump.
Lady.
Okay, so my impersonation...
Wait, did she actually fart, or was that just a sound effect? Whatever, it's not funny enough to replay it.
Bill Clinton.
I did not get a blowjob from Monica. That was...
How do you fuck that up? That's like one of the most famous moments in recent fucking history, and you fucked it up.
I'm not high either right now.
Oh my god, that was terrible.
Okay.
Thumbs down. Share. Okay, share.
If I could turn back down.
All right, this will end. If I could find this must end. This cannot continue.
You believe?
Let's let's turn up the grading though. I'm done with that video, but we're gonna keep going. I'm gonna annoy the fuck out of all of you until you hate me. That is like enough green vegetables to feed a fucking family of rabbits. Oh my god. Holy shit. Oh, fucking food. Is my video done downloading yet? Oh, it show is. It show is done. Alright, we get to skip that one. We're out of... We lost 40 people during the hee-hee montage, but we are out of the frying pan into the fire now. Let's see. This starts at 395. That is... I can do this. 5, 6, 35. 635. All right.
Hey, Fat Girl Files. This is things that are... I have a sense of humor about these things. Some people might think, well, that's kind of sad. Maybe you shouldn't laugh about these things. Well, it's like laugh or cry, right? So some of these things I find to be really, you know, kind of embarrassed. Maybe I should be more embarrassed about them, but I really just sometimes have a lack of shame.
Stop calling me a feeder.
So these are TMI. I'm not a feeder. Fat girl facts. Things that have, after they've happened, have embarrassed me and had made me say I need to lose weight, but never do. My god, my hair, guys! I look like it's that haircut from that friggin' girl from Game of Thrones there.
No, it's fucking not.
Arya Stark. Anyway, so the first one is this is really bad. Sometimes you get things stuck in crevices that, you know, thin people don't have. So, for example, one time I had a Cheeto stuck in my bra. Probably was there all day. I took my bra off, you know, to get busy with my boyfriend, and there was a Cheeto. So I hope he was hungry. Anyway.
Okay, let's recap. This is Fat Girl TMI. TMI number one. She found a Cheeto in her tits that had been there all day. I want you guys to tell me, chat, be honest. I'll know if you're lying to me. Do you think she ate that fucking Cheeto? Do you think she ate that Cheeto? Because you know what I think. You know what I think. I think she fucking ate that Cheeto. You know she ate that fucking Cheeto. Pull it. I don't need a fucking pull it. I know exactly what happened. And so do all you motherfuckers.
Anyway, another thing... was that one time I also had I felt like a little bit of a, you know, a pain, like a nagging pain down in my roll somewhere. And, you know, I was like, what is that? You know? So finally I went to discover what it was. I went searching and there was a Pringles cap stuck somewhere in my roll. Probably was there for like 12 hours. Once you pop, you can't stop.
Can you imagine? Okay, recap. Feeder tip number two. I can't. TMI number two, not feeder tip number two. I don't know where the fuck that came from. It's you guys are poisoning me. You guys are poisoning me. You're fucking wiring my brain and giving me Freudian slips. Fuck you. Fuck you all. God damn it, motherfuckers. TMI number two. She found a Pringles lid stuck in her fat rolls for 12 hours, and she didn't notice it was there. No, fuck all. Fuck
another thing fuck that assholes, really embarrassing is that, you know, like, I have a really big, large backside. Big butt. And I cannot lie. You know, I used to love that song on a side note. You know, I was like, yes, he's defending big girls. But then it was like, I like big butts and I cannot lie. All you other brothers can't deny. When a girl walks in with an itty bitty waist. Right there, that's when it stopped for me. I was like, itty bitty waist.
Josh ate the Cheeto.
Anyway, so I have a problem with TP. I have to be really careful.
Okay. Everybody shut the fuck up and listen. Listen good.
Like, itty bitty waist. I'm excluded. Anyway, so I have a problem with TP. I have to be really careful. TP tends to get stuck. And, I don't know. My butt cheeks are just, like, really compressed together, I guess. I don't know what it is. I told you this was TMI. I hope you're all laughing at me. That's the point of this video.
We are, baby. We are.
It happened where I don't notice, and I go to get intimate with a guy. It's happened many times, where they find a little bit of a surprise, and I think they try to be... I remember I told you the story time about how that happened to me at the gynecologist. Well, yeah, I think, like, one guy just tried to be really nice about it and not say anything and just kind of picked it out. And I felt him pick it out and I was like, oh my god, this was a toilet paper. Okay, another thing that was really embarrassing and actually, like, I want to blush, but I think...
Okay. A fat TMI number three. Sometimes you get a bunch of paper stuck between your ass cheeks, and when you're getting fucked, you know, a guy's going to help you out and pluck those little dingleberries for you. I hate when that happens.
Thank God I bought a shade of foundation too light, because you'd be seeing my redness more. Anyway, one time I got pulled over by a cop, and I was swerving on the highway. So this is dangerous, so don't ever do this. And don't snack and drive. Anyway, I was swerving, so I got pulled over. And, you know, so the cop, you know, cop asked me to pull down my window and says, have you been drinking? And honestly, guys, I almost wish that it was booze related, because I think it would have been less embarrassing and shameful than having to admit that, no, I was just reaching for a McDonald's snack wrap. So there's one more that I guess I want to share with you guys for now. I just kind of, like, could only think of, like, five things for now, but I'm sure I'll think of more. But there was a time where I had my friends over and, you know, I thought it would be a good idea to make them a vegetable platter. And I make this, like, really awesome dip. A lot of you probably have had this before and can agree how good it is. But it is sour cream mixed with a packet of Lipton or Knorr now, I guess, onion soup mix. And the thing with that soup mix is that it makes me very gassy. I don't know what it is.
Oh, God. Onion,
I don't know what it is. Makes me gassy. And, well, it's like a double whammy of embarrassment, because we were sitting at the table playing a card game, and we were, you know, had snacks previously on the vegetables and dip. And all of a sudden, I didn't even have a warning. My kitchen chair broke beneath me, and I went flying down, and on the way down, I farted, like, really loud, and I did my pathetic non-scream, like, farted, and I smashed my head on my metallic, it's like a big metal garbage bin, and I didn't feel it. I must have a really hard head, because there's like a I should show you guys, there's a huge dent in it, still works, so I'm not gonna throw it out. But there was a huge dent, and like big dent. Like, I'm surprised I didn't have a concussion. So I was just like, you know, everyone was like, are you okay? Are you okay? But no, that was, I think
I just,
the embarrassment was the worst part of that whole
I
thing.
Just love the
anyways, guys, that's
the collateral fucking damage TMI, that she has.
Fat girl facts for you. So yeah, so leave me some comments. Let me know how you guys are doing. And thank you so much for watching.
I just love that she is like a nonstop, like, walking fucking disaster. Just destroying everything, shitting all over the fucking place. Though, I need to find a clip. I do need to find a clip. Give me a second. Not that one. Not that one. This is completely unrelated. This is just some random shit that I want to... that I want to... just want to ruin your fucking day with. Give me a second. Didn't even plan for this. Oh, there it is. Right where I left it.
Just out of my fucking face, you fucking tease! Let me suck the air out of your asshole! Ass! Ass! Titties! Mommy! Give me milkies!
Mommy, let me smell your shit stank!
Oh yes, my dear! Quite pungent indeed!
I just love that fucking video so much. The way he's like pathetic and crying after it is just, it's comedic perfection. And I'm just thinking, of Chantel, like, farting and destroying, like, collateral fucking damage as she farts and destroys shit in her fucking house. Ugh. My webcam got shut. Oh shit, I'm exposed. Ah, jeez. Yeah, for all the girls out there watching this, that's what male humor is. Get fucking culturally enriched, motherfucker. All right, I think. Let's say I covered BB. I covered her being fucking gross. I covered her history. I covered her being mean-spirited. I covered her manipulating people. I covered that. I went over the TMI. I saw the fucking clip where she shit herself. I think that we should watch, and this is where I'm going to need intoxication to help me. We're just going to watch one of her vlogs. Not a particular vlog, just one of them. I don't have this planned out. I don't have one in mind. I'm literally just going to pick a random fucking video. And we're going to watch it. And I'll put it at 2x because it might be boring. But let's sort by views. Let's see what the best hits look like. Large, super cheesy pizza mukbang. Mukbang eaten shio cheesy lasagna. Five Guys mukbang eaten show eating. Ew! What the fuck? Oh my god. I hadn't seen the full title of this video. She puts the word eating show in all of her videos, which I guess is what Korean, the mukbang means in Korean. But this one in particular, Five Guys mukbang eating show, eating noises and licking fingers. Oh, we're watching this one. Oh, wait, hold up. I'm going to put it at time and a half.
And
I'm gonna get my vodka. Here it is, my co-pilot, my best friend in these trying times, and we're gonna fucking watch this shit. How many more fetishes are you hiding from us, Josh? Oh, if only you knew. What's a mukbang? I don't know. I might be pronouncing it wrong. If you're making fun of my pronunciation, remember, I'm just an idiot. Don't hold me liable for my own actions. A mukbang in Korea. I'll actually just show you this. Twitch TV. We're going to get culturally enriched by the Korean this time. Let's see, just chatting. Is this it? It's crazy how the just chatting is so high up on the list now. I think that's it. I don't think they have a specific one for eating. But you go to this just chatting. You have some thoughts. You have some guys. You have a titty lady working out. That's always great. There's a Korean chick just chatting. Usually there's a couple videos of people just eating. And it's, I don't know if it's for lonely people or if it's like a cultural thing in Korea, but fat women in America have adopted this and try to eat and copy the success of pretty Korean women doing the same. And all they attract is actual feeders who want to see them eat themselves to death. I think there might be a different category for feeding. See, I don't look this up. I'm not into feeding, so I don't know where it's at, if I haven't made that clear enough. But basically, that's the gist of it. It's just people eating and talking to each other. And that's all she does. And it's pretty fucking clear that her audience is people who actually are creepy fucking weirdo feeders, right? As evidenced by the fact she titles her videos, Five Guys Mukbang Eating, Show Eating Noises and Licking Fingers. Here we go.
Hey guys. So, it's another hot day, but it's rainy. Today I have for you, it doesn't even sound bad, but Five Guys Burger and Fries. I'm going to the gym after this. Isn't that appropriate?
No, you're fucking not. Don't fucking lie to me.
The total for this meal, I got the veggie burger and a small mini fry. And a bottle of water came up to $10.66 Canadian. The burger was $3.99. It's basically just veggies on a bun. Grease, gotta love it. I believe they fry their fries in peanut oil, which is like a healthier alternative, you know? So let's get these fries. Oh my God. Look at these bad boys. Oh my God. I got the Cajun fries.
Oh man, I wish I had some french fries right now.
And ketchup.
Oh, please no people smacking their chops infuriate me. Oh, trust me, I'm the worst. I'm so fucking OCD. I'm legit fucking OCD about eating.
All you really need is a mini fry.
But I suffer. I suffer like Jesus Christ.
They dump a whole bunch on top, so.
For your amusement.
Mm-mm-mm. No, I have no idea what the calories are for this. I don't give a shit.
You're gonna fuck off now. Rest in peace, soul got.
First meal of the day. Going to the gym after, and then when I get home.
Muted.
After the gym, I've been eating kind of the same thing. A whole bag.
If you're not listening to this, you're a pussy. We're doing this together.
Sauteed. And then I either put lentils or green peas or some kind of protein
family.
Source in it.
Ohana means family, you fuckers.
And then I have a bowl of...
Don't abandon me to watch this by myself. I need your emotional support. Look at that hoof.
Blueberries?
I'm not masturbating. Oh my God, I'm being fucking character assassinated here.
They're expensive, but... They have so many antioxidants and vitamins.
French fries?
Which is so good. Do they have like a Cajun spice on them? I don't know. Yum. Mmm.
Yeah, she's carb loading to lift late. She's bulking right now. She's in bear mode. No, I didn't say I'm muted. I'm saying that people are tapping out. People are already muting their fucking mics. I see those 13 people that have left. Cowards, the weakest, the first to fall, the first to break rank. I will drive our numbers to the fucking ground as we watch.
Get my food. Ooh, they're spicy. Toto's Africa came on and like everyone in the restaurant started singing it. I was like, except for me.
And then everybody clapped, oh. Right?
Oh, God. I hate this song. It's overplayed.
Freedom fries.
So,
Josh,
summer's here.
Josh should coat his dick in Cajun spice for her. Hey, now, that's offensive.
And your for my Americans, July 4th is coming, and for Canadians, like me, tomorrow is Canada Day. July 1st. And everybody usually who lives in Ottawa at the, you know, which is the capital of Canada.
We're only a fourth of the way there. Let me speed
the
it up a
capital city
bit.
Of Canada. Everybody usually goes down to the Parliament.
Go. Go quickly. Eat. Ah, close your mouth.
For celebration. And what this year, it's our 150th anniversary. So it's a big one, but I'm not going near there because...
Don't talk with your mouth.
The security, the crowds, the lineups. There's been terrorist threats. Of course there has.
You can't fap to this. You're fucking weak.
So, I'm not going down there. Fuck that. And I hope there's no terrorism.
Oh, God, she's so bad with the eating. If this was at normal speed, her munching sounds would be like twice as...
I'm not even chewing. I'm so hungry. I woke up late today.
Oh, she's just
my live stream's pretty late, and then I stay up for like an hour.
Stuffing it in.
Trying to fall asleep.
Oh, God.
It's 3:34 in the morning. And then I get up, have a liter of water.
Swallow your food! Why are you doing this?
I got ready just like briefly. Had a quick shower, didn't wash my hair. And then I'm gonna go to the gym after this. I have to get a few things at the store.
She's just used her tits to wipe her.
After I'm done that, like my food will back up, digest it, and I'll go work out.
How do you think the Cheetos get there?
I'm gonna film snippets of my workouts because I'm going to put it in a vlog on my other channel, so if you haven't checked out my other channel, it's always linked in the description below.
I hate noisy... Dude, I'm telling you.
Or you can follow me.
I'm the worst. I'm suffering the most, which is why...
I believe that you can have an eating channel.
I'm intoxicating myself.
I definitely do. Gotta watch what you're eating.
1/4 speed. Oh, no.
For me, I'm not doing...
Oh, it doesn't play noise.
Low calorie... I'm just doing... Vegan. So
she's not vegan. Oh no. This is worse.
Mostly plant-based.
No. We're going back to time and half. Look, she's not even done with the first bite. She's stuffing in two more. Oh God.
It's kind of like an experiment. I want to see if like I still have been losing weight, but
it's like a conveyor belt. It's not chewing.
These fries are probably like I don't know how many calories. 500. They're good. Mm. Look at this fry.
You can't? You have to. Don't give up now. We're making it.
I love licking my fingers, though.
We're 8 minutes. We're halfway through, guys. We're almost there.
Let's get to the burger.
Oh, yeah. Let's get to the burger.
Which I hear is very messy, so, and I forgot to get extra napkins, so this is going to be interesting.
This only solidifies my belief in the final fat solution. Are you talking about a soap world order?
Mushroom. I'm going to try to hold it. So, basically,
14 calories? That's a lot. That's a lot for one meal. Holy shit, that burger.
Mushrooms,
just check my screen.
Green peppers and pickles.
Oh, jeez. Attack on Berg. They're the prey and we are the hunters.
Barbecue sauce.
Da, 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 da.
Bite for you guys. Beauty bite.
Holy shit. Her bites are so fucking clean through that burger. She's like, she's like attacking it. Halftime for burger.
This is one good meal.
She's mixing it. She's crossing the beams. Don't cross the beams, lady. It's dangerous. We're getting an instant replay. Look at her eyes. They're fixated on that French fry. Come to me. No, don't go for the lick. We're at halftime now! Ah! She wiped it on her tits again. Come on, get napkins in the bag, bro.
I love bed cheese.
I wish the button was multigrain, but so I'm so hungry. So I'm feeling better. Last night in my live stream, I wasn't feeling the greatest. But I do feel better now.
I hope you choke on your borscht, Josh.
I don't know. Maybe it was like soy. Maybe I have a soy allergy.
Oh my god, my head hurts. I wasn't expecting that.
The tofu inside those spring wraps? I don't know. After I ate those. But it could also be because I'm eating a lot more fiber than usual.
That berg, it's like...
Tummy was just a little bit upset, you know?
It's like a tenth of it is gone every bite. Stop crying! Stop mixing your foe! Oh, that's so gross. Ah.
So if you get them small fry, it's more like you're getting a medium because of all the extra fries they dump on top.
Oh, God, she's so loud.
At least they have a vegetarian or a vegan option.
Oh, this is rough.
I don't know if there's eggs in this bread. If there is, then it would be vegetarian. The barbecue sauce is so good. These fries, though, they're so good.
She's so fucking... She's getting worse as time goes on. Like, her hunger... Is not it's not abating. It's becoming more ravenous. She becomes quicker and quicker with each bite and louder. Stop!
Every day.
That's so gross. That burger's almost fucking gone. Oh no! It tried to run away from the brat beast.
I'm gonna need to
clean it. It was unsuccessful.
Or after.
Well, hold on.
Yes, ma'am.
If you can, look at her nose. Look at her nose, right there.
I'm gonna need to clean up my car after.
Right there.
Yes, ma'am.
Do you see her, like, her nostrils are flaring, like she can smell the food. And it's increasing the frenzy. The frenzy is like a war drum. It's beating faster and faster. Needs to destroy the berg. Annihilate the berg.
So delicious.
We've lost 60 viewers, but we will continue. We're almost there. I'm not a feeder. Fuck off. I'm just making things more interesting. Oh, Jesus. She fucking packed that shit down. That's crazy. How is she still alive? She did like a brush down.
Well, I'm going to go to the gym soon. Trying to do some blogging there.
Oh god.
So like the gym I'm at, I have access to like all the gyms of the same kind in the city with my membership. So the one I'm gonna go to near my place is an all women's gym.
Tell me about your gym.
I've never been to one of those. So I'm excited to see what it's about. So yeah, just thanks for sharing that quick meal with me, guys. I've been wanting to try Five Guys Veggie Burger for a long time.
And food crumbs. I really enjoyed that. So thank you so much for watching. And I'll see you next time. Bye, guys.
We did it. We did it. We lost 60 viewers, but we did it. Pour a 40 out for the fallen, who couldn't make it to the finish line. We're gonna have to bury along the way. But we did it. We are the champions. All right. MSPEX insists that I play this last one, and then I think I'm gonna play my outro song. I don't think anybody can take much more of this shit. We're gonna fucking start jumping off of cliffs and shit. How long is this one? 8 minutes. All right, let's do it. This is a good final video. Chanters, the babe,
I'm singing to. Hey guys, hey guys, hey, 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 hey. Hi. As you can see, my fake eyelashes are no more because, well, these were them. Arumika luxury 3D lashes from Amazon. I don't know where the other one is. Don't I, Sam? I don't know. I honestly don't. I don't know if it was Sam or if it was me. I don't know where it is. I can't find it. So today I'm doing a video on, was requested. And I just want to share it anyways with you guys. I wanted to show you how I cover my bald spots, because show you without the stuff I use. So this is, my hair is very thin up here, as you can see.
Holy fuck. That's so serious. Yeah,
it's very thin on top.
Her fucking balding is like as bad as Julie Terry. But on the bottom
it seems to be growing out fairly nice. But I need to cover it with some stuff. And I found some really great stuff. And so I'll just show you my hair routine, I guess, really quick here. So the first thing I do is I brush my hair. I stopped straightening it because it's not good for your hair. You know, in the long run. You can use like a anti-heat thing, but... So I use R&B. This is a heavy-duty leave-in moisturizer. So I don't need much because then it will weigh my hair down. So I just take a bit like this. Like, literally, that much.
Josh must be red wrong right now. Why do you have to bully really me? Good.
That's mostly why I like it.
Is balding like my new fetish, too?
Like this. I just want, like, the curls to be more... Like, I want my hair to be less, less frizzy, you know? And a bit more shiny. So that's what I do. Go like this. Go like this. And you're probably wondering, are you ashamed? Are you embarrassed? No, not at all. I used to be so embarrassed about my thinning hair, because especially after that, remember I told you that one guy I was seeing, like, before I met BB there, he, like, the jerk one, he was like, oh my god, you're balding, like, excuse me? That made me really self-conscious, and I think that's what he wanted to do. He wanted to degrade me, to make me feel like shit, so I wouldn't, like, you know, maybe so I wouldn't leave him, I don't know.
Well, it's because you're fucking balding. Anyways, he's just being honest.
That's what I do with this stuff. And, oh, it smells great. So this is the product that I use for the bald. It's Kaboki. I just got a shipment. I keep it, like, I make sure I'm stocked up because I don't want to go without. So it's called Kaboki. This is not a sponsored video or anything. I want to see your magic. I don't even know I exist. Maybe they do. Maybe I order so much of it. But this is the Kaboki stuff. So I'm going to show you how I apply it. The before and after. So yeah. So let's get to.
As evidence that this is not a cyberbullying stream, I think I've done more to harm my reputation than Chantel's. So clearly this is not a cyberbullying stream. Because if it were, it would have completely backfired.
Let's take it up. This is building fibers. Basically the ingredients are... it says on the website, I guess it doesn't really say on the package, but it's like building fibers. It's plant-based, apparently, but they have different colors. So I just take it.
Where the fuck are they?
And you're supposed to just, like, rub it.
What's so loud?
But I actually shake.
It sounds like they're in an airport or something.
See how it just kind of
It apparently binds to. I know that.
Is that something? No, that has to be.
It's going to be like Fallout right now.
It oh, you know what it
binds
is?
To your head.
BB's playing fucking Call of Duty in the background. Here, I can hear it.
And I go like that.
Listen, you can hear him playing Call of Duty.
I'm bald. I'm going to go here. There's a bald patch.
Wait, it's just paint?
You're asking
She's
why?
She's just painting her fucking bald spot over?
Genetically, my mom also has very thin hair.
Oh my god, how embarrassing.
She doesn't have to use this, though. But she is a lot smaller than I am. I think that it is weight-related. The weight is causing my hormonal issues. So I think that has something to do with it.
I would play Call of Duty with BB. Press 1 if you would play Call of Duty with BB.
Now, if I were to leave it like that, you can see how it... But do you see how it just, like, covers? It is, like, amazing stuff, guys. Like, for real. So, you can't leave it like that.
Did you hear him?
A spray. If you're in the
He's
US,
complaining
you
about the game in the background.
But in the US, they have a spray. It's a binding spray. So you spray it after, and it holds everything in place. Now,
I heard him groan
because
he got killed.
What you can do is just use a bit of hairspray.
That's really funny.
Yeah. So I'm hoping once I get my hormones regulated that my hair will grow back, but I don't know.
Why are
so
her hormones fucked up? Sorry, I was listening to BB play Call of Duty.
And I just go like this because I don't want the fallout to happen all day long. One time I was in the store with my friend, and she didn't know. She doesn't know I use this stuff, right? And she was like, "You have black all over your forehead," and like immediately I was like, "It's eyeshadow." So embarrassed. But anyway, now I'm.
You get embarrassed about that, but you'll tell the story about how you shit. Like a fucking fire hose all over somebody's bathroom.
I honestly
bathroom.
Think being in the public eye and, like, people just picking apart everything about you, like, it just, you just start to just not give a shit and accept what you are, you know? Like, pick on your looks, like, who cares, you know? So it's not, like, perfect. Like, you can get it more perfect than that. But yeah, basically... Kind of looks
fatness fucks up your hormones. It makes you go bald, really?
God darn it.
In women, you would expect the estrogen to, like, I don't know. Being fat messes up your hormones. Guys who are obese release more estrogen. Women who are obese don't produce enough estrogen. I did not know that. I thought fat cells produce estrogen in general.
All right. So there you have the finished product. So that's how I do my hair. You can put more, like, it's kind of thin here. But, it basically covers the bald, so, yeah. So that's what I do with my hair, guys. I just thought I would show you a quick video of that. And, yeah, so no more eyelashes for now. I might buy some new ones, but I might buy some that are not as...
It's weird watching somebody fall apart in real
time. I think
those
are okay if you have really big eyes, you know, like, nice, big, dramatic eyes. I don't have really big eyes. I have smaller eyes. And, like, smaller facial features. So I don't know if they kind of, like, they look really fake, you know? But I did like how they look, and a lot of you did, but I don't know where the other one is.
Somebody said something about how I'm leaving behind, like, a trail of bald women after I feed them into
obesity. Did you lose your game, babe?
Okay. Wait. Did you hear BB
Anyways,
in the
guys,
background?
So just a quick video today. I am still doing the 15th of July will be the last day for the smoothie thing, and then
burger
on
that
head. Monday. I want to plan, like, you know, I really want to eat like buffalo cauliflower wings and do like a mystery Monday or something. But yeah, I'll have an update video this week on the whole smoothie thing, and
I plan
on doing a weigh-in on the 15th. So.
Look in the background by the painting. You can see BB.
But yeah, I'll have an update video.
He's either playing a game that requires standing up, or he's like stretching after his match. You can see the shadow. So. BB is alive.
Anyways,
he's desperate for fresh air out of the prison. All right, I'm done. I can't take any. If I watch any more of these videos. People are going to be adding this to my fucking ED page, saying that I'm a feeder. I can't take it anymore. That's Chantel. Sarah Lot, the foodie beauty. She's fat. She's also mean. And she has imprisoned a poor Senegalese man who just wants to go home to his family and hopefully will never return. He will simply stay at home. And because Ohana means family, and you can't take him with you. That's it. Thank you guys very much for watching. We peaked at somewhere like very close to like 1,900 people. That's fucking crazy. I hope you guys had fun. I'm going to pop in my outro song, and that will be it. Let's see if there's anything I need to read. Josh, hook her up with Truthfully Trisha. I don't know. Did you hear the last time she tried to have a lesbian encounter? It didn't go too fucking well. I don't think I'd wish Chantal's sexual healing on my worst fucking enemy. That's just me. All right, where's my song at? There it is. All right, take it easy, guys. He walks alone.